Stream looks good. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, 12 of the finest ship designers have fought their way through an armada of foes to earn the right to fight in the intergalactic petri dish that is the Reassembly Arena. Today, just one of those 12 excellent competitors will rise to the top and receive the grand prize of not only a random Steam game key, a Deluxe Gaming branded button, but a Deluxe Gaming branded t-shirt as well. Joining me once again for today's final main event is the incredible, the talented, the charismatic, and rhythmically inclined, hailing from the savannas of South Africa, my friend, Lapsapnow.
Hello, everybody. Good to be here again.
I think that was an excellent introduction, don't you?
I couldn't even hear what you said, Rob. Apparently the monkeys stopped carrying my internet for a few seconds.
Oh, that's disappointing. Oh, that's too bad, because it was such a great introduction. I thought you'd really appreciate that. So, as I said, As I said, we have the final 12 competitors of all three divisions. We have the four finalists, semi-finalists from three divisions that we've had over the last, I think, month and a half now. We've sort of carried this as far as long as we could possibly go to get to the finals here. But I'm really excited. This is going to be a really interesting battle. Now, each of these divisions had their own winners, and each of these people that you see on the screen right now have already won a prize. They have already won a random Steam game key, and they have already won a Deluxe Gaming branded lapel button. Woohoo!
Victory!
So now these last 12 competitors are going to fight to get that t-shirt. So this is going to be really exciting. I'm really curious to see. I have no idea who's going to win this. I have no idea.
There's so many crazy designs here. All right, how about we read off the names?
That sounds wonderful.
Okay. Go ahead, Rob.
From the top, we have Centurion version 2 from Skipper LB, which is an interesting competitor with... I have my eye on this one. There's something inside of me that says the Centurion's gonna do very well here. He's got this ring of armor around three or four of his ships, and it's done very, very, very well. It's served him well in the first division. I'm curious to see how that acts in this against some of these really, really good competitors, but he might be an underdog here. I don't know. And then we have gonna win by Neon 53295. This one is a faction one design thumper. I don't remember it exactly, but who knows? Who knows? You never know, because we had a lot of faction one. I think we had three faction ones.
We had a surprising amount. It was actually all quite awesome to see that not only faction four and faction seven got in.
Yeah, in Division 1, it was three Faction 1 winners and one Faction 7. And then we have Seeing Eyes by Duke Slayer. Duke Slayer, I believe, is in the chat, which is another Faction 1 design. Very interesting. And then the infamous Halorasur, Remnants of a Bygone Era, which is sort of... He's infamous for these particular designs, a very tight-knit, fleet-driven group. They always fly in little fleets and destroy... It's amazing to watch, actually. All right, I'll let you take Division 2 there, Luke.
All right. So next we have Splinter with the new Roman Navy. An interesting faction one. It is faction one. Yes, it is.
Yes.
An interesting faction one fleet that looks gorgeous from afar.
Amazing. Yes.
And then next we have Mons Poobus, who is obviously faction four with his Skirmish Forever. Faction four skirmishes, of course.
Yes.
Then we have Bahamut with Flippin' Good Time.
Very
good. He's faction four flipper shooter.
I will say something about Bahamut, though. This is another one I've got my eye on. He could do very well in this. I don't know. It's the only competitor in the final 12 that is just one ship. One ship that's 50,000 P. Anyway, go on.
Yes, it's a hell of a risk. Yes. And then next we have Sudlu with the Serrated Armada, which may not look like it, but it is actually Faction 7.
Yes.
It's actually Sentinel, not Faction 1, which is actually quite hilarious. Mm-hmm. And go, Rob.
All right, and for the Division 3 finalists, we have Drone Dreadnought Power. This is about as close as we have to a troll ship fleet in the finals. Now, these guys are fast enough. They have more than enough engines, but each of these ships have very thick Faction 1 armor, very hard to penetrate, and that served them well in the Division 3 finals. And then we have the 147th Imperial Expeditionary Fleet by Simple Krum. Now, this is, of course, a fleet with a Empire Strikes Back Super Star Destroyer. Really gorgeous fleet. And it is not Faction 1, it is Faction 7, although it does look a lot like Faction 1. Then we have Waste 47's It Has to Be Done. I don't know what he had to get done, but he certainly did very well reaching the finals of Division 3 with his Faction 1, or Faction 7 little melee fleet. Really interesting fleet, actually. And then finally, last but not least, we have Xeno666, and it's because I hate dying to meta. All you see here is one of his spacers, but he has it's a really tiny little scatter fleet. It's amazing to watch this work. This is another one that I kind of have my eye on. I can't predict. If you were to put money on any of these fleets, Luke, who would you put money on?
Oh my gosh, I have no idea. I'd have to put it on either Bahamut, yeah. or Mons, just out of yeah. habit. Or Halorsa. So, Bahamut, Halorsa, and
Halorsa's ships individually are, I mean, they're good. They're good individually. But the thing about Halorsa's fleet is that they all fly together, and we'll get to see that. But it's an amazing thing. And then you've got Mons Pupus, who's kind of got a scatter skirmish faction 4 fleet with all very small similar ships. I talked to him the other day. He said they aren't identical, but most of them, they look very, very similar, and it's amazing. It's a Faction 4 fleet that kind of flies in little groups too, which is neat. But all of these have their reasons why they are here today, and I'm really curious to see how this is going to turn out. Now, another thing that we're going to do differently today is that we're not going to be running this as a regular single elimination tournament. We're going to run this as a double elimination tournament, which means each competitor has the opportunity to lose at least once and still move on. If they lose twice, they are out of the competition, which means this is going to go a little bit longer for 12 ships, but I think it's way more fair.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, I mean, from the few tournaments that I've done where I've used double elimination, it really does make sure that everyone actually gets a chance to show off their powers.
Everybody gets a fair shot, yeah.
Yes, because there's some fleets that absolutely get wrecked, and other ones that, when given the right chance, decimate, which is, it's always fun to see.
Yes. Jonathan Champion is asking why we're not doing pool. Can you answer that question for us?
Because pool takes a metric ton of a long time. We might be here until the next year, so it's not a very good idea.
Even these 12 ships would take like 3-4 hours. It would take a long
time. take too long. Also, by the way, we have greetings from Michigan as well.
Oh, hello.
Greetings from Michigan. Welcome. Mr. Merlin,
welcome. Excellent. Greetings from Canada.
And everyone else who says hi. Sorry, I'm just trying to find people who are actually saying hi from insert country here, or state, or whatever. Also, supplegrams here. All right, so Rob, shall we begin?
There is one final question we have to ask both our viewers and yourself. Luke, do you know what question that is?
No.
Are you wearing pants today? Because that seems to be the theme of the tournament, whether or not people are wearing pants. Because today is the championship finals, I've decided to wear pants. Luke, how about yourself?
I wear pants all the time.
Okay, so apparently for Luke, this isn't a question, but... Ryan Bennett in chat, thank you very much for letting me know that you're not wearing pants. Thank you. All right, so I think we're ready to go. Are you ready, Luke?
Let's go. Yes, I'm ready. Let's launch.
All right, here we go. The first competitors are Centurion version 2 versus Halorsa. Let's see what happens.
Oh, gosh. I'm not sure what to feel about this.
Those Centurions, man, I tell you, with that ring of armor, it just makes that... It's so hard to penetrate that. I think it's 2 or 3 blocks deep. It's crazy deep.
Yes, it is, actually. It looks like it. I don't know.
Can you see? Yeah. Luke, can you see? Okay.
I can see. Oh, no, I can see. It's all right. Thank you, Rob. Okay. I can see. It's just I'm not sure whether he's using small blocks or big blocks. Is he using... I think... Those are big blocks. Those are big blocks, yeah.
Yeah. It's very thick, and I don't think in the first division, I think he was he the winner. I don't remember who the winner was of the first division, but I think he might have been the winner, and it's just because of that thick armor.
That as well as those little rammer ships. We saw one of them slice right through one of Alorsa's battleships in the beginning.
Oh yeah,
actually. So there is that, but Yeah, these, and his missiles, I mean,
these
no
little
idea.
Suckers, they're just covered in the spiky armor, of course. Now, the nice thing about Hellerser ships is, like I said, they kind of fly together. They fly in tandem, like you'd see. Oh, except they took a nuke to the face. Whoops. Yikes.
Yeah, the nukes.
Yeah, it doesn't look like Hellerser is actually going to pull off and do those things that I always see him do. But the bright side of double elimination is that he's going to have another chance if he does lose this.
Yeah, unless somebody else beats Centurion, in which case we'll have to see the same sad thing again.
Yes, that's true. That's true.
Which can happen. Can we also just take a moment to appreciate the amount of nukes currently on in play?
Yes, it's absolutely terrifying. he's already down to 5 ships. Poor Hellerser. He's just getting. He really hasn't shown here. I was bragging about Hellerser. I'm like, look what he can do. But look, I think he's just been. He's been preoccupied with those little ships, and he hasn't been able to organize his ships like he normally is able to do. So maybe on the next round he might pull it off. But I don't think he's going to get it for this round.
Yeah. Unfortunately.
Yeah.
But yeah, I mean, the thing is, I think over a longer time, with the old 3 minutes, maybe Hellerser might have been able to catch up with the points, but I don't know with all those nukes.
Don't know. I think those nukes will eventually get him. I mean, he's only got 4 ships. If I don't know how many of the big main ships that he starts with, but yeah.
Ow.
Yeah, he just took another
nuke.
I
think he starts with about 5.
Two down with 1 nuke. That is highly efficient. Well,
they done. Also got stuck together, which is hilarious. Okay, he starts with 6.
Starts with 6 of his main ships there, and yeah, he's getting pretty distracted by those little guys. And those little guys, even though they're small, they do have, of course, that spike armor, which can just cut through faction 1 pretty like butter. So,
Yeah.
Mind you, does the spike armor actually go through weapons as easily as it does armor? I don't believe so, does it?
I think I'm pretty sure it does actually go through everything exactly the same, because it treats it all as a block, and so it doesn't really care.
So it doesn't matter what kind of block that is.
Okay. Yeah, it doesn't matter. However, if the block does have melee, then even if it's just melee of 0%, because normal sentinel armor, the spiky bits have like 500% or something crazy. So even if you just have melee armor with like 0, say in a modern faction, anything that tries to ram you will actually bounce off effectively.
Really? Okay.
Most of the time. Yeah. Just a bit of interesting stuff. Yeah.
Hellerser just can't get that moment to get his group together to focus on one ship at a time. I think it's also the quantity of ships that's actually causing him trouble here.
Yeah.
Because Centurion's grouping his ships together like that, so I think Hellerser's finding it difficult to focus. The AI is finding it difficult to get his ships together. Whatever.
Except seeds, for some reason, says Sumple Crumb. Are seeds RAM impervious, Sumple? I've actually never tested that, so I have no idea.
Are which impervious?
Seeds. Sumple's saying, I hope he's talking to me. He says, except seeds for some reason. So I guess he's saying that seeds can resist
seeds?
Melee.
Well, what do you mean by seeds?
Anything with, you know plants, and they have little seed pods.
Yeah.
Now, that they actually have a function on them called seed, which lets them, like, behave in a certain way and do seed things. Okay, I'm not going to bore anyone with it, but basically, apparently, according to Sumble, they resist melee, which is
interesting.
Interesting. Yeah. Next up, building ships out of seeds.
Building ships out of seeds. Interesting. That'd be an interesting tournament. All right. So, I think Centurion's going to do very well in this tournament. The being that he was just able to take on Hellerser that easily, without any really, he didn't even break a sweat here. He's about double Hellerser's points. Hellerser only has 2 ships left versus those 14 ships. 3 of those they almost look like little space stations, don't they? Yeah.
Yeah, actually.
But Hellerser will be back. Hellerser will be back. And now we have New Roman Navy versus Xeno 666. Yes.
Ooh, she's like it. I love that barrage of torpedoes that just took out 3 ships.
That's amazing.
Another one down. Another one bats the dust.
Now, this is an interesting fight, because I think about during the event, or before the events, I think Xenos and Splinter have experimented a lot with their fleets against each other. Like, they've tested their fleets. So I think Splinter was gearing to try and beat Xenos's fleet, and I think Xenos was trying to gear to beat Splinter's fleet. So I actually don't know who's going to win this. Although, because I think this main ship is, the Vesuvius, I think he calls it, is going to be a little bit tricky to beat.
Yeah, it's a heavily armored Titan.
Yes.
Look at that thing. And the amount of missiles just pouring out of it, and the drones. No, go.
No, please do.
I didn't have anything interesting to say.
Yeah, I just don't know how they're going to get through all those missiles. Now, these little ships of Xenos's are really brilliant. They're really kind of cool. Some of them have nukes on them. Yeah. Some of them are totally non-symmetrical, too. They're really interesting designs. I think there's, I don't know how many nukes he has in the fleet. I think he's probably in chat, and he could probably tell us. Maybe that's the one thing that might penetrate that large ship, but I don't know. I don't know if they'll actually get to that point.
Yeah. Also, the thing is, he has so many station shields, he might be quite safe, but yeah, I have no idea.
That is a lot of station shields. Look at that. That's crazy.
Oh, gosh.
But thrusted. Splinter has lost almost all of his ships here, all of his big ships.
Yes. Yeah. Ryan Bennett says, you guys are too polite. Be more savage.
How do you want to be more savage? What does that mean? Like,
exactly.
Thing is, it's hard to say bad things about any of the fleets that we're going to see today. All of these guys have already proven themselves and are depending on the situation, right?
Yeah, Rom, I think he more means you and I being like, oh no, you go first. No, but you go first.
Oh,
sir, but please, you go first. Please. That's all I think.
Just out of curiosity, in South Africa, are you guys notoriously known for being extra polite as well?
I'm not sure. Depends where you go. Some places can be downright terrifying.
Okay,
other places can be lovely.
But I guess that's the same with Canada. But I guess we're sort of stereotypically known for being polite. And I think that's mostly true, but definitely that's definitely not all the time, for sure.
Yeah. Yeah.
There are people that move here from the States, so no, I'm just kidding. Totally kidding. Totally kidding, though, in chat. Totally kidding.
Shots fired.
Shots fired. There you go. I'm being savage to the States instead.
Black Hawk down. Black Hawk down.
Strike Force Vesuvius got taken down the first round against Xenos. We are experiencing a little bit of slowdown in time with some of these. I expect that we're going to see more of that with Xenos' fleet because there is so much going on. He's got a lot of ships in the air. We're going to see a little bit of slowdown in time. So that will slow down the tournament overall, but there are going to be some fast fights, like the fights with Bahamut. I think, generally speaking, those are going to be pretty quick.
Shame Bahamut.
Yeah. those nukes eventually took down those shields. How dare you? How dare you, Ryan Bennett says in chat.
Bahamut also says, more savage? Your mother's mass is greater than or equal to the average mass of a red giant. Oh, sly. Okay.
Your mom is so... Really? We're gonna degrade ourselves to your mom is so fat jokes? Really? Really?
Really, Bahamut?
Really?
Yeah, Bahamut took it for you. I think we understand where his fleet came from.
Yes.
Badly constructed.
I wonder.
Sorry,
Bahamut.
No, I'm just
criticizing. Did you just say his ship is badly constructed? that's hilarious, Bahamut. Come on.
Oh my gosh. Simple crap. Okay, anyway, the new Roman Navy is winning.
Are they, though? I don't know that they are. I think they're losing by points. And think Sorry, go ahead.
I thought I was looking at more of new Roman Navy than I was of Xenos. No, but Xenos is definitely winning on this.
Yeah, those nukes are just...
Only by 2,000.
I think Xenos has that double advantage. He's got the nukes, so he's got the advantage of nukes, and he's got the swarm capabilities. He's got these little tiny ships that move really fast, makes it extremely difficult for a fleet like New Roman Navy to kind of grab hold of anybody. I mean, he's done some damage, but...
So I'm coughing to death. Sorry, it's fine.
Oh, no, that's okay. I was just going to let you cough to death. You are allowed to cough.
Also, can I just say that New Roman Navy seems to have a battery of what? What are those, like?
The missiles?
Or... Oh my gosh, yes, yeah, he has circles of torpedo launchers.
Oh, that. Yes! That's yeah, isn't incredible. That cool?
That's genius. Yeah, because I was seeing this, like, circle of torpedo flying. That's brilliant. That's brilliant, Splinter. Well done. She's like it. That's actually a good idea, because then you hit everything, and those are deadly missiles.
Yeah, they're targeting every direction all the time. It's brilliant. It's really
Splinter's
great.
Splinter's actually gonna—he's actually gonna win this 32,000 points.
You think so? He's look at. Yeah, the points are just ahead, but all it's gonna take is—he got it. Unbelievable. Round two, yeah. New Roman Navy takes it. See, this is why. Yeah, like I said, I think these guys fought a lot at the beginning. So that's it. That was hold on. That was—I'm making sure to keep track of who's winning and losing here. We have one loss for Xenos already. And then we were here, Hallerzer and Xenos.
Yeah, let's see how this goes. Oh my gosh.
What's your prediction, Luke?
Nukes. I'm worried that Hallerzer is going to get distracted by the ships, which he is, and then get nuked from behind. So my prediction is Xenos may take this, but then again, Hallerzer is very maneuverable. He's taking up those ships quite quickly, and the antimatters are just... taking chunks out of this little craft.
Oh yeah, look at that. For a second there I thought, oh, he might pull it off because his Hellerser's ships were starting to group up nicely, and then Xenos just flew right through the center of them and distracted them, and that's it. That's it. I think that's over. Wow. Yeah even the points.
Just like it.
But then we have ships stuck together, which is always nice. Beautiful. One of his spacers stuck on one of his ships.
Oh my word. I Amazing. I love watching ships get stuck together and then kind of do a weird ballet.
So the spacers try to go left, the ship is trying to go right, they're fighting against each other. It's hilarious.
Yeah. Oh gosh.
Hallerzer is down to five ships.
One of his big motherships just got nuked.
Oh yes. Three ships. three ships left. It looks like he's got part of two of his capital ships left. One of them only has part of it left.
Yeah, I called it.
Oh, boom. Yeah, the nukes really. How do you deal with that? I think it's just the maneuverability. If his ships were slower, I think Hallerzer beat many Faction 7 fleets in tournaments, yeah. in the Division 1 semifinals. But yeah. Just the size of these ships makes all the difference. The maneuverability of these ships make all the difference. There we go. Round two.
Yeah. Unless he hits a couple things with those torpedoes. Oh, okay. Well. I'm sorry. We're just watching one ship get annihilated now. Seeing its bits just go flying out. Incredible speeds is... always funny.
It's glorious. I hate to say it, Hallerzer, but it's wonderful watching your ships just get shattered in one shot from these nukes. Just they literally explode and parts just fly everywhere throughout the universe. Some lonely planet's receiving parts from this green ship somewhere in the universe.
Yeah.
Boom! Oh man.
Ooh, oh. Like...
Well, Hallerzer, I'm afraid.
David Mason.
Yeah. I'm afraid, Hallerzer, you're probably going to lose this, which means that would be your second loss already in this double elimination tournament, which will knock you out, unfortunately. But you fought valiantly, sir, very valiantly, and you came a long way. You really did. For Faction 1, you really came a long way.
Yeah, the problem is he just got first against Nukas twice.
Yeah, two times in a row. You just sort of faced that's it. That's all over. One ship left. Everybody's going after that one little ship. There he is. Look at him run. Oh my god! I can't even tell where he is. He's so small. Oh, there he is. He's gone. All right. Sorry, Hallerzer. That looks like you are out of the competition. Well, you fought well, though. You fought well. Here we go. Serrated Armada versus Skirmish Forever. Serrated Armada is Sudlu, and we have Mons Poobus.
Yeah, there we go. There's that highly effective skirmish spam.
Four skirmish, like little groups, like they travel in little groups. I love that.
Yeah, and the other effective thing is that since there's so many of them, you're not relying on one big ship to try and target. You have a lot of little craft who are gonna trying to maintain my consistent fire. So I think it usually ends up working better. You never know.
Yeah. You see, and this is a battle where I wouldn't know what was going to happen right away, because sometimes the AI decides to just fly into ships. Even you know, like the Faction 4 ships, they might have decided to fly right into, and all of Serrated Armada's ships are, of course, covered in that melee armor.
Yeah.
Which would have ended that Faction 4 fleet very quickly. But now that Mons Poopus kind of has, he can outrun them and maintain that nice melee sniper range and just blast away. And I don't think, he'll probably win by points. I don't think he's going to win by defeating all of Serrated Armada's fleet, just because that armor is so good.
Yeah, yeah.
Looks like it. Yeah, two little arenas of battle here. We've got five or six ships sort of taking on these guys. But, you know, Serrated Armada's fleet, they're not really engaging. Like, what do they go... Oh, hold on. What are these little guys? Yeah. So these little guys...
Little drone distractors.
Yeah, so...
So he has little drones to deal with stuff as well. That's good.
It's good. It's actually probably won this battle because it's kept those Serrated Armada sort of at bay while they deal with one ship at a time.
Yeah, yeah.
Ooh, beautifully done.
Indeed. shame, sadly. But you have one more chance. Against Xenos.
Yes.
So that should be interesting, because we're going to have two Faction 7s facing off. Nuke v. Nuke.
Which is always interesting, and I think, well, the nukes, I will almost always put my money on small, tiny, fast, maneuverable nuking ships versus large nuking ships, almost always.
Yeah, yeah. Big compass and mucus. Yeah, indeed. Yeah.
Round two!
Round two! Fight! Let's look at chat.
Yeah, those nukes just aren't connecting. I don't know how many... What's that?
Oh, Splinterman says, better warm yourself on nukes.
Yeah, they keep you nice and toasty warm in the winter. Oh, that'd be nice. Can somebody nuke Canada? I'm a little chilly. No, please don't. Please don't. I just insulted the United States. You never know.
Yes. Might be going too far.
Might be going too far.
He'll also Spanish from chat. He failed the emperor. What on earth?
Was Hallowser in chat?
That's the guy. No, I don't know where. No, he wasn't. I don't think Hallowser's... Hallowser. No, I can't see him.
I don't think he was here today.
Shame, Hallowser.
Ah, well. You know what? I always appreciate those Faction 1 designs of yours. And like I said, it did very, very well. I think we're gonna... Even though I think Mons Poopus is gonna defeat Serrated Armada here, I think we're gonna see Serrated Armada come back with perhaps another... fight. I think his next round of battle is probably going to be a little bit better. Mons Poopus is probably the best competitor for him. I mean, in the sense of Mons Poopus is going to win. Like, it's a worse competitor for him, I mean. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know what you mean. I know exactly what you mean.
Like, I think Serrated Armada will do better in a different situation.
Mm-hmm.
30 seconds to go, and it's always, you know, some of these fights, you know they're going to be long. It's going to be the full minute 30. So you gotta kind of just be patient, but we know how it's gonna end, but you never know, because as long as there is nukes in the air, things could change in an instant. And Serrated Armada has 9/11 ships
Mons
left.
Mons is actually here. Jeffrey Walker.
Oh yeah, Jeffrey, hello! Yes, so also...
Mons Jeffrey, Poopus.
Yeah, Jeffrey Walker also, Mons Poopus, runs his own tournaments, I believe monthly. On his own channel, and I think it's NMSS, is that right?
Yes, I think you are correct.
Yes, yeah. So...
I'm sure he'll yell at us in chat if we're wrong, so that's
yes.
Fine.
So just look up NMSS Tournaments for Reassembly, and you'll come up with Mons Poopus's tournaments, which are quite entertaining.
Yeah, they're quite fun, and yeah, he used to even do modern tournaments. I'm not sure if he does them anymore.
I think so, I think he still does those, I'm pretty sure. Here we go. So that's one loss for Sudlu, and then we're moving on to Seeing Eyes by Duke Slayer, who is in chat. And I think I'm gonna win by who is that? That is Neon 5295.
Oh gosh. Oh gosh. Yes. This is an interesting fight. You see a lot of I think I'm gonna win ships just flying about. Look at them. Yeah. Even some of the big growl, they're just whizzing everywhere.
They get a little bit close and then they scatter, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. The giant giant death balls actually getting a bit taken out of them. Jeez.
What faction is Duke Slayer? That's faction one, as expected. So those are station shields in there. Oh, wow. But how did this ship get destroyed? I don't understand. What happened?
I have no idea. I wasn't even watching.
The shields were up like this, and all of a sudden it was dead. That's crazy. Those plasmas do some really crazy damage when they're getting close, though.
Mm. So Dash the Guy sent you a straw poll about Bahamut. Also, Bahamut says, appreciate the plug, gentlemen. I actually have a modded tournament's rules posted currently. So he is actually hosting a modded tournament.
Ah, perfect. Oh,
wonderful.
Yeah, please go ahead and check out his channel. I might post a link later. I'm watching this right now, but yeah, he does. He's way more regular than I am. I'm down to once a year now. So, he knows more about the game. He's probably forgotten more about the game than I ever knew. So there you go.
Yes, and I'll definitely be participating. So if you want to come and smack me about the head, go and find this tournament.
Wow, again, we're making it, you know, the full minute 30 for these battles. Winning by points, seeing eyes by Duke Slayer, round one, moving on to round two. I thought Duke Slayer was going to do better on there, but you know what? Just because of those station shields, I thought he would be able to pull it off. But he, of course, won't have the same kind of firepower that I think is going to have, because those station shields use up so much P to put on a ship.
Yeah. I mean, you could get almost 200 plasma cannons for the price of that one shield.
Yeah. So
No, not even. Not 200. Maybe 50.
Yeah, which is substantial, because those plasma cannons
do a
huge amount of damage, enough to be able to penetrate those shields. But who knows? I still think it's anybody's ball game here. It's possible that I think I'm going to win. Could... Hold on.
Yeah. GTLGZ Mammons asks, what is this game playing? reassembly, my man.
Yes.
Go have a read in the description. Usually Rob leaves a thoroughly... good description of the games he plays, so go have a look down there.
Yeah, it's a top-down space shooter where you get to build and design your own ships. You will lose hundreds of hours, potentially, building and designing stuff in sort of this organic world, organic universe, sort of in a campaign. It's really fascinating. But anyway, there is a tournament part of this game that, of course, we like to grasp onto, and people can build whatever they want. Well, based on some limitations, some rules that we set beforehand. And so we do these battles. And there's prizes.
Indeed.
Yeah. I think Duke's gonna pull it off. Yeah, he's almost up to 40,000 points. I think I'm gonna win. Now, I have a question, and I think I already have the answer to the question. Maybe, you know, entertain me here for a second. But if a weapon hits a station shield, they do not get points for that.
No.
If it doesn't penetrate the shield.
Yeah. If it hits it, but the shield doesn't go down, doesn't hit any components inside, no.
So there's a lesson to be learned here. If you play extra defensive when you're fighting, at least a faction one, the extra shields are worthwhile. There we go. Duke Slayer pulls it off. Wonderful. Good job.
Nice.
But I think Neon 53295 is not out.
Also, the thing is, when back in the oldie tournaments, you used to get points just by hitting shields as well. much matter what you hit. So for me, the old tournaments were quite broken in that if someone was using shields to protect themselves, the other person would get an inevitable point lead.
That's
because the shields are usually bigger than the actual ship, and they soak up a lot of damage.
That's right.
So that was always my problem. But now, of course, we have armor that doesn't have a p-value, and thusly doesn't actually give you... But the interesting thing there is that if you're going up against Sentinels, their very armor is p, so it costs power points. So if you hit Sentinel armor, it will actually cost them far more than it would cost you normally if you just get your normal, say, Terran armor.
Which I think is kind of fair, because that melee armor is actually a weapon, and it's also very tough. It's very, very tough to cut.
Yeah.
So I think that's kind of fair.
It's incredibly strong.
I still believe that there should be a P value for destroying armor. I think that should be included. Like, just even if it's 1 point for regular armor, that way we wouldn't have to have limitations for troll ships. We could have tournaments without saying, you know, you can't have a troll ship. If you have a troll ship, that's fine, but expect to possibly lose by points. And that's one of the reasons why I've actually held off on doing these tournaments for a long time, because you know, the troll ships were such a game changer. You could win a tournament no problem just by building this giant block of nothing and just hold out the enemy with drones and the B faction. It was pretty crazy.
Yeah. I remember the number J.
The number J. Oh, Salmon. What was that? The number J, and that was Shaky Box, I believe.
Shaky Box. Yeah. It was good old Simon. I miss Simon. We need to get him back one day.
Oh, I think he's in our Discord. He's in our Discord, I think.
Yeah, he's just not too active. Simon.
No, he's quiet. He's a quiet guy.
He's a quiet chap. He's quite reserved, which is always good.
Yeah, Serrated Armada is going to pull it off, and if he pulls it off in round two here, he will have eliminated... Oh, no, hold on. Hold on. I think I'm going to win, actually, won the first round of this. Hold on, what's going on?
I don't think we've been paying attention.
Where am I? I thought... Are they fighting...
Serrated Armada.
Hold on.
This is... I think we're going to win.
We were chatting, and I lost track of what's going on here. So
We literally lost track of the last minute and a half, and who won the previous battle. Well done,
us. Pretty sure it was Serrated Armada. Yeah, well done, us. We were talking about Shaky Box. That's important.
Okay, I give up. My mind is shot. I don't know what's going on.
Is it possible that these two are fighting all over again? All right, so round one goes to Serrated Armada. Right, no. I think I'm going to win. Sorry, he lost against. Yeah, no, okay. I'm back on track here. So yeah, Serrated Armada. Okay, this is round two. I think I'm going to win. Lost against. Where are they here? Seeing Eyes, that's right, Duke Slayer. So this is the second round against the Serrated Armada. And if I think I'm going to win, loses this battle, he is out of the competition. And it looks like that might just happen. I think he's... A couple ships flew into that armor, but mostly it's nukes. You have to be able to dodge those nukes or be able to have some kind of layer of missile fire or something to prevent those nukes from hitting when your faction won. Otherwise, you're in big trouble.
Yeah. Yeah, sorry about that, Duke. I do enjoy the fleet, though, actually. Out of functionality, I like it, but you've sadly gotten kicked. Nukes. Boom.
Yeah.
Boom. Ah. Oh gosh, darn it.
Yeah.
I'm waiting for. Go ahead, Rob.
No, please go ahead. Go ahead.
I'm waiting for two ships to, like we saw last time, where they lock fronts and do like a pirouette. So I'm waiting for that to happen.
Oh, I'm sure we'll see some dancing hilarious. Today. I'm sure. And you'll have to sing while they dance, right?
Oh gosh, no.
Oh gosh, no.
Da, 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 dun, dun. Oh gosh.
Those nukes are cleaning up. I don't think that Neon can pull it off here. I think this is probably where we're going to say goodbye to him.
Yeah.
Once again, we're making it through the entire minute 30 of these battles, which is surprising so far. The thing is, I timed out a test run of not these 12 competitors, a different group of 12 competitors, just random people from the tournament, just to see how long a double elimination tournament would take. And it was about an hour and 20 minutes, somewhere around there. But if every battle ends up being a minute 30, it might be a little bit longer than that. I don't know. We'll see. Either way, Serrated Armada is just about done. 18 seconds to go. I don't think he's going to finish off all of those ships from I Think I'm Going to Win. I think it's going to be strictly by points, winning by more than four times. I Think I'm Going to Win.
Yeah. Sorry, Duke Slayer.
No, it's not Duke Slayer. That is Neon 53.
Isn't it? Is it?
Neon 53295. Duke Slayer 1 against Neon. Yeah.
Oh yes, it's seeing. Okay, I'm confused.
So that's it for Neon 53295. You are out of the competition. You fought valiantly, sir. But moving on. Good job, Sudlu. Good luck. Good job. Ah, this could be interesting. Centurion Skipper B versus the New Roman Navy and the Vesuvius. I don't know who's gonna win this. I think the nukes might win it, but I don't know. Oh, look at him just slam against that armor. Look at that array of missiles.
The other
boom,
thing
boom,
is,
boom. Oh, that was awesome.
Ooh. If those torpedoes end up hitting those circles centurions, they're gonna go down quickly. And the thing is, they can't move fast enough to get out of the way. So
yes,
that's a hell of a danger.
Dutch the guy, I call it melee armor. I also call Bolsheviks schmutz launchers. I also call shotgun snot launchers. So I can call things whatever I want. just so you,
gosh.
Yeah, but the melee armor that's around here, or is it, I don't know what kind of armor is that? That's melee armor, of course, right? I think.
Sorry, I'm reading chat.
Oh, that's fine. So looks like Splinter, he's focusing on some of these smaller ships and getting distracted. If he focused all of that firepower from the Vesuvius onto some of these little Centurion station things, he might pull it off, but he keeps getting distracted by the little guys. I have to stress, when you're building a fleet, if you're going to have some big ships, make sure you have a bunch of these little ships. They will confuse the hell out of big ships, out of big fleets like poor little Splinter's fleet here. Because if his firepower from his big capital ships here were focused on Centurion ship, Centurion's big ships, they would be going down. But
yeah.
And that still might happen, but that's a lot of armor to punch through. Here we go.
Yeah. You need those torpedoes.
Here we go. Come on, do it, cut through.
Not a single nuke is getting through, though, because of that missile swarm and all the drones.
And I...
Whoosh, just like it.
Man, it's hard to get through all that armor. And here comes all of those cutters. Oh, no. Oh, bam. Laser to the face. Lovely.
Taken out. I hope those cutters don't have nukes on them, because then not going to be a good day.
I don't think so. I don't think these have nukes on them. No, they have annihilators just this.
Gauss beams. They have gauss.
Oh, gauss beams are good. Gauss beams are good. I like gauss beams.
Gauss beams
can kind of pinch underneath those shields too, can't they? They can kind of sneak underneath and hit under shields.
Yeah. Certain lasers. The obliterator. I think I told you this last time.
Yes.
The obliterator and possibly the gauss. I haven't done enough testing. Wait, where are you guys chatting?
Beautiful job with the Vesuvius there, taking out one of those Centurions. I don't know that it's going to be enough.
God,
he may still win by points. I don't know. You are doing substantial damage. You're still destroying ships, Splinter, so you might just pull this off. You're so close for points. Nobody can call it at this point. 35 very long seconds to go. We've got some slowdown here. It might be because we're streaming too. I don't know what's causing the slowdown. I mean, I don't think there's that much going on the screen, but...
I think it's actually the amount of missiles.
You think so? Okay.
Yeah, there's a lot of them. Especially out of that mothership. If you have a closer look,
Yeah, they're just coming out of every orifice out of that mothership. Yes.
Thousands upon millions. Besides that, I actually have no idea what's causing the slowdown. Yeah, interesting.
You know what? I think that New Roman Navy might just pull this off by just a smidge. Just barely in points, 22 seconds to go. If Centurion brings in any of those small ships now, I think that Vesuvius will just waste them, and that'll just give him even more points. He's not going to catch up to those big Centurion ships. I think it's almost over. Less than 20 seconds to go.
Ooh.
Good fight. I actually thought that Centurion was going to win this. Oh, no, he is.
Centurion has won this. I was about to say.
The points changed. Wow, just like that.
No.
Oh, it's so close. It's so close. 10, 13 seconds to go. I think Centurion's got it. I don't think... Oh, hold on. Actually, he's doing a little bit more damage. 300-point difference. Still a 300-point... Oh, so close. 100-point difference. Little 150 points. 7 seconds to go. The last shot fired here is going to make all the difference in the world. 6 seconds to go. I don't know. So close. Four.
This is very intense.
Three. Splinter's probably just. And I think Centurion's gonna steal round one. And I mean steal. Stole it. Whoa, Centurion.
Splinter had a torpedo. Had a torpedo like centimeters from one of Centurion's ships. It was about to hit. It just.
Amazing.
just missed. It would have taken the thing out and pushed him over the limit. That's
amazing. Crazy. That was so close. That is crazy close. Once again, I think if the new Roman Navy could focus on destroying at least one, if not two, of those main Centurion ships, he might stand a chance. Otherwise, I don't know. It's anybody's ballgame. My money at the beginning of this was actually, I was kind of thinking Centurion might be the winner of this tournament. Just because of that, that ring of armor is so bloody effective.
Yeah. It's very tough as well. Each two block is of like, what? 1,000 HP?
Yeah, it's a lot of 4,000. Hit points. Yeah, it's a lot of hit points.
If it's a scale 2 block, then it's 4,000 HP.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. Every gun needs to be targeted on one of those ships to actually take it out for a substantial amount of time, too.
Yeah, and the thing is that I'm pretty sure those blocks are actually only worth one power point, which is weird. They're larger than the normal 1x1 plate, but they're actually less expensive. Don't know why.
I wonder if that's a bug.
I think so. It might have to do with balance. Like, they... I don't know. Like, the idea of having a smaller block that can fit onto a little craft and be lighter. Maybe that should cost more because of convenience sake, but whatever. Oh. Okay, anyway, to the battle!
Oh no, I'm just noting that the capital ship, the Vesuvius there, took a couple direct hits with the nukes. The station shields held, though, knocked out the front of the ship, but the station shields held. They're close enough. Oh, the shields are going down. Two nukes to the face. Oh no, the Vesuvius, I think Centurion's gonna pull it off this time. Maybe. Oh, those shields are going back up. I don't know. He's starting to target the capital ships. He's actually penetrated the armor, the very thick armor. I don't know. What do you think, Luke?
I don't think he's going to be able to pull it off. There are too many nukes too close nukes. To him. The too shields are nukes. Buckling. Captain, it's going down.
I can't take it anymore, Captain. There it goes. The Vesuvius just went down. It's falling apart. That's it for the new Roman Navy. They are finished. 43 seconds to go, but that's okay. It's going to speed up a little bit because we don't have nearly as many missiles in the air. Ah, that's too bad, Splinter. That is too bad. Quite unfortunate. Yeah. But
so is one shot.
It's only one loss. You get another chance.
Yes.
Oh, that's too bad. I thought maybe he might pull it off because he penetrated that armor, but nope.
Yeah. Wow, it's been an hour already, by the way.
Has it been an hour already?
Yeah. Oh
my God. We're getting a lot more slowdown. During my test last night, I wasn't getting this much slowdown, but I think it might be some of the fleets that we're running here. They're pretty intense when it comes to the number of drones and or missiles, so...
Yeah. Incredible. Cheers, Spinter. No!
8 seconds ago. It's all over. It's all over. We've accepted it's all over. There's nothing I don't... There's nothing that these little ships from the new Roman Navy could do now to stop it.
Yeah.
That's it. It's all over. There you go. Splinter, you still got one more chance in the tournament because this is double elimination, which is, I like that. I like the double elimination thing, although this is, it's going to take it takes some time. I hope you're ready for the long haul there, Luke.
It's all right.
Oh, this is...
I've actually finished my bowl of mac and cheese.
So, oh, fantastic. You're Lion Roni.
Lion Roni. I've also finished my water, so...
Fantastic. And now we have Xeno666 in his tiny little Faction 7 fleet versus the new Roman Navy. I don't know. I think we've seen this. Haven't we seen this one already? I think the first time around, I think Splinter beat Xenos. I think this is their second battle.
Oh, yes. Yes. I remember his subordinate craft getting sliced in half, and that's happening right now.
Yes.
Yeah, we've seen this battle.
I think it's kind of a crapshoot with these two fleets against each other, but I think in the end, I don't know. Because Splinter won it the first time, right? I have no idea. I would, if I was betting, I would put money on Xenos. And no offense, Splinter, I just think it's the size of the ships, the maneuverability and all that stuff, but that if that capital ship just weighs them once they get even close, and those nukes can't get near them, I don't know.
I like Splinter Man's, his reply to this. Oh, yes! And he says, Xeno still has a chance. Like, I imagine him, like, waving his hand, going, like, he still has a chance against me. A puny one.
A tiny little chance.
hey, now, I didn't lose the... Okay, so now Splinter says, hey now, I didn't ask to lose the round one by 0.2 seconds. It's true, he basically did, which is sad.
Oh, Zenos cuts through one of those two capital ships with one ship. Oh, one little ship just cuts him in half. Oh, brutal blow for the new Roman Navy. Almost losing. He didn't quite lose that capital ship, but he might as well have. He's trying to assemble those...
Still love the fleet anyway.
Oh, it's gorgeous. It's an absolutely gorgeous fleet. Splinter Man should be proud. Keep in mind also, this is a Faction 1 fleet, and he's doing very well, all things considered. He has beaten this fleet already once before. Who knows? It's still up in the air. New Roman Navy does have the points, but there are still nukes, and that can change everything.
Nukes up in the air. Nukes up in the air.
Nukes in the air.
Oh, gosh.
Actually, I think, to be honest with you, I think Splinter is actually doing better this time than he did last time. Look at all the nukes just spreading perfect little circle around him. Almost looks like a burst pulse.
Torpedoes.
Yeah, torpedoes. Yeah. That's right. Yeah. Beautiful.
I'd love a torpedo pulse.
Very nice.
That's gorgeous. Pulse. Yeah.
Torpedo pulse. I wish they were... Torpedo pulse.
A torpedo pulse.
I love it.
Yeah.
I think he's going to pull it off again. Zenos, you are getting destroyed by Splinter. I am really surprised. Zenos,
I'm going to blame the missiles.
You blame the missiles, yeah.
I blame the missiles. Yeah. Go on.
I don't know. Everybody's going to blame me because people like to blame me. But that's okay. New Roman Navy. The Vesuvius just took a nuke to the butt. Uh-oh. And they're all coming in at once. There could be a lot of nukes. There is a lot of nukes in the air. Oh, they all went down. Those missiles took him out again.
1 second, Splinter.
There we go. New Roman Navy pulls it off. Zenos, I am surprised. You were in my top three list for sure. I thought you were going to be able to pull this off. If Zenos loses this battle, he is out of the tournament. Wow. Destroyed twice by the same foe.
Jeffrey Montes says... So them getting cut in half is actually kind of a good thing. It means they're not ramming the Vesuvius, which is quite true.
the little capital ships, yes. I totally agree. Oh, nukes. Nukes coming in hard. Already destroying the front of the Vesuvius. If he takes a couple more nukes. Another nuke in, but still did not penetrate those station shields. Those station shields are just magnificent. Oh, just like boom. Multiple nukes hitting. Crazy. Zenos, you have an absolutely brilliant fleet. I've seen it do crazy things. I am surprised Splinter beat you here. I am really, really surprised. And no offense to you, Splinter. I just thought small ships with nukes would beat large Faction 1 ships with lots of missiles. That's just what I thought. But I'm wrong. I am totally wrong. But it's not over yet. We still have a minute to go. A long minute. Zeno 666 in chat is like, ban missiles. Yes. Ban all weapons. Ban all weapons that do damage to my ships. Yes.
Ban. Also says, ban distractions.
Ban distractions. Ban missile distraction. Look at those torps. Beautiful.
Torpy. I love that torp ring. It's beautiful.
Amazing.
I need to build. I want one. I want one of my own. I want it.
Makes you almost want to build a ship with multiple rings like that, so they all start. So you can't, no matter what you do, you can't get not hit by those torps.
Yeah, it'd basically be a bullet hell at that point. Yeah, it'd be amazing.
That'd be amazing. That'd be really cool.
Missile spam is not to be underestimated, says Supplecrumb.
Yeah, Zenos might pull this off. He's at 19,000 points. He might win by points, but as soon as Zenos stops getting distracted by those little ships, he's going to start moving in his ships to the Vesuvius, and the Vesuvius is just perfectly designed to take out those little ships, nukes or not.
Zangrath says, ban ships!
Ban ships!
Ban engines! Ban engines! Oh, gosh.
No weapons, no ships, no engines. That's it. We'll just have a blank screen during the tournaments.
Whoever has the blankest side wins.
Whoever says the nicest thing about Laps wins the tournament. Laps is a really great guy. Well, I think Laps is my hero. Well, I think... Yeah, whatever. And then we decide who gives Laps the best compliment, and then they'll say ban compliments. So
Oh my gosh.
18 seconds to go. That's close. Xenos, you might pull this off. You might pull off round three, but you're starting to move in on that Vesuvius. You're going to take more damage here. I don't know.
The Visconuvius. The Visconuvius of the Oopsabuvius. It causes damage to anyone who come closest. With nukes and tubulus.
Oh, here it goes. It's close. It's within a couple thousand. It's not going to take much to sway it either way. 5 seconds to go. I think Xenos has got round two. Maybe. It's so close. Oh, Xenos pulls off a win. He has another chance. Here we go, folks.
Round three.
I've been practicing, see? Yeah, I've been practicing your little round three
thing. Yes, I see. Simple Crumb says ban laps.
Ban laps? No! We can't ban laps! No. What would these tournaments be without lap apps now? I mean, seriously. Oh! Splinter took a big hit there.
Laps is better than tacos. Laps is the new world. This is starting to get creepy. Could be a stop.
Just remember, Laps is wearing pants. He's better than all of us. I'm wearing pants today. That's okay. I'm wearing pants.
Amazing. Well done, Roland. I'm very glad. Yeah. Very glad, by the way.
Probably one of the creepiest things I've ever done in my introductions is everybody wearing pants. It's only creepy when I'm saying I'm not wearing pants, actually. That's when it's like, really? You're not wearing pants? Ooh.
Yeah.
So I did wear pants.
Bands Deluxe. It's not actually Deluxe. It's Delulz. Ban Delulz. All right, no more laughing, everybody. We can stop it. That should be acceptable.
Yes. Laps is better than cats. No, I don't know. I don't know. I really like cats. The Vesuvius got hit hard by nukes and destroyed. Oh. That means, folks, Xenos is moving on. Unbelievable turn of events. I can't believe it. Xenos pulled it off. And that means that Splinter's second loss, folks. That means Splinter gets knocked out of the competition. Unbelievable turn of events. I cannot believe it. Wow, that is crazy.
Sheesh.
You never know with those nukes. Mark. Unbelievable. Unbelievable turn of events. Xenos pulls it off. Good job,
Splinter.
Xenos.
Splinter says, I've totally engineered my fleets to come down the last second for maximum entertainment value.
Brilliant job, Splinter. You did fantastic. But that's it. Unbelievable. Now we're back to Mons Pumas versus Duke Slayer. I don't think either of these guys have lost a battle yet. Nope, we've got neither one of these competitors have lost a battle yet, but I have a feeling that Mons Pubis is kind of chewing those station shields, man. I don't know. I can't believe it. That was incredible. Those nukes, those final moments, those nukes taking out that Vesuvius. Incredible. Great fight. Absolutely brilliant.
Beautiful. Yeah, rip Splinter. Sorry, Splinter.
Yeah, I'm so sorry. But highly entertaining. Highly, highly entertaining. Rob, good fight.
Rob, can you hear me?
I can hear you. Hello?
Okay, sorry. It's just you were breaking up for me, and so is the screen share.
Screen share. Okay, I hit a button, I think so that might better. Have been a problem there.
I need to go kick a monkey. Give me a second.
Is a monkey running your internet? I hear there's a baboon problem down there, but there we go. Mons Pumas wins the first round against Duke Slayer. He kind of cleaned you up there, Duke Slayer. Unfortunately, a lot of firepower coming from Mons Pumas. And they can hit you, they can outrange you. I think that's what the problem is here for you. I think with Duke Slayer, he's got a serious problem trying to reach Mons Pupus. And keep in mind, every one of Mons Pupus' shots there actually destroys all of those missiles coming in, as long as he's targeted towards those ships. I don't think Duke Slayer is going to stand a chance here, unfortunately. Duke Slayer, this will be your first loss, Duke Slayer, in the grand scheme of things, so don't sweat it too much yet. Yeah, he's just cleaning you up. Wow. Can you hear me okay, Luke?
Yes. Okay. All right. Yeah. Oh gosh.
Mons Pumas has not lost one ship yet. Crazy.
Yeah. Oh, she's like it. Mons, why? Why Mons?
Mons. Oh, the humanity. Oh. What do you, really, what do you suppose a faction four creature? A faction four creature. What do you think he would look like if he was like sitting in the ship? What do you think that creature would look like? The one that's controlling these ships. I imagine them being kind of, I don't know, very technologically, like almost cyborgy kind of.
I imagine. For Monster's ship, I'm imagining his profile image.
Beautiful job.
Which is him holding a glass and just at a in like a tuxedo, just kind of standing there and going like, "This way, craft, or that way, fire, fire, back, go back, to left, go to the right."
Duke Slayer against Serena Armada. Both of these competitors have lost one, I believe. Hold on, let me just check. Both of these competitors have lost one, so whoever loses this battle will not continue on in the competition. I'm really thinking that Duke Slayer might win? I don't know. I was about to say win, and then I noticed that his ships are getting chewed. Oh, no! Oh, man. Duke Slayer, you did so well, and then all of a sudden, oh, no!
Yeah.
Nukes. Yeah. Nukes.
Nukes. Nukes. Nukes. Nukes, and more, and even more nukes.
And even more nukes.
Oh, gosh, man. Oh, the humanity.
Oh, the humanity! Oh my god, you man! No! No! Sorry.
Rob, what are you even doing?
I have no idea. There it goes, Duke Slayer, round one done. You've gotta come back on this one, buddy, or that's it. Oh, you still have two ships. Really? Where are they? Oh, there they are.
Not me!
Run! Oh crap!
Oh god.
One ship, where is he? There he is. There you go. Serrated Armada. What's that?
Some people are imagining whales flying ships, which I can get behind. I can support whales flying ships.
Whales, yeah, absolutely. Oh, nuke. Oh, Jesus, that armor just cut through one of them with a combination of a nuke, too. Oh, see, I think Duke Slayer's only chance here is to keep his ships together, but if he keeps his ships together, they're just gonna get slaughtered by those nukes. They're just not fast enough to dodge. There's not enough firepower coming out of them. I don't think there's a chance for him to pull this off, which means Sunlu's gonna move on, but there's still some time, but I don't know. What do you think, Luke?
I don't know.
I don't even know anymore, man. I don't know.
I don't know if you can pull it through. I hope he can, but I don't think he can. The point lead is too much.
Oh,
too
yeah.
much.
Although he is chewing on that one ship, but it just takes too much to take down one of Sudlu's ships. That armor is very similar to, I mean, it's, of course, it's the same armor as Centurion's. Skipper B's fleet, right? It's the same armor, it's just a different configuration, but it's just as tough to blow through it. Doesn't matter. It just, yeah. Those ships are just too big.
Yeah.
Not enough firepower. You gotta have way more firepower to pull that off.
Not enough firepower.
Duke Slayer, one more. How many ships? Two ships left. You've got one more little ship and one. Yeah, that's it. Nuke to the face. And one little ship.
Yeah.
He's running. You can only run so fast before those missiles will get you, though.
Hey, Ares 106.
Hey, Ares, how's it going?
Yeah.
Ares has predicted that Mons Poopus will win this tournament. I don't know. I think Mons Poopus has an excellent fleet. Who would you put your money on?
Shame, Duke Slayer.
Who would you put your money on, Luke?
Out of all of them, from what I've seen, I'd have to put it on Mons. Who else is still
Duke
here?
Duke Slayer is out of the competition. You fought valiantly. Serrated Armada moves on. And, oh, this is going to be interesting. Xenos versus Serrated. Mons Poopus, yeah. I think is in my top three, but I don't know if Mons Poopus is going to win this, though.
Yeah, I'm thinking about Bahamut's flipper.
Right? We haven't even seen Bahamut yet today. Wow.
Yeah, as well as the drone dreadnought. That one. Yeah.
Yeah, it has really thick Faction 1 armor. It might do okay, but I don't know if it's not in my top three. And it's not because I don't think it's a good design. I think that there's enough anti-Faction 1 fleets to be able to take that out. I think with enough nukers and stuff. I think my prediction is that it will be Mons. I think Xenos might be up there, and I think Mons Poopus will be up there. So for our top three, Mons Poopus, Xenos, and Centurion. Those are my top three.
Yeah.
Not to say there's anything wrong with Serrated Armada, but I just here's an example of how Serrated Armada just can't deal with these little ships. He can't get out of the way of those nukes, man. He just boom, boom, there we go. And if Serrated Armada loses this battle, or the next battle in round two, then that's it. He's out of the competition. Xenos cleaned up. Good job, Xenos.
That was a sweet nuke. Bah, God. Yeah. Jeez. Sorry, sadly. It's very interesting. It's very entertaining to see Xenos ships just swarm and fire nukes indiscriminately into the nest of the ships.
Just love it. I just love that when they just start going off all at once, like popcorn, like pop 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 pop.
Yeah,
that's so great. I love it. There is a competitor we haven't seen yet who might also. I mean, I don't know. I honestly don't know. It's so hard to tell. But I think after this, we also haven't seen Waste 47's fleet, which won. Mm. I think he won. Did he? Or he came close to winning the third division. I don't remember. That's also a good competitor too as well. I don't know. We haven't seen Bahamut and we haven't seen Waze 47. We haven't seen Supplecrumb, and we haven't seen X Derp's Drone Dreadnoughts either. Yeah, but not that I think the Drone Dreadnoughts are a bad fleet by any means. I just think he's got enough stuff that's designed to kill big ships kicking around like Xenos' fleet here. It's just that's what it does. It kills big ships.
Yeah.
Boom, there we go. Unfortunately, Serrated Armada, suddenly you are out of the competition. You fought valiantly, sir. We're on to Waste 47 versus Bahamut. Nice. Oh, this could be interesting. Here we go.
So Waste brought knives to a gunfight, basically, is what we're getting at.
Buddy, super fast. Look at him come at. Oh, look at him come at him. Oh, once those knives get in, though, that'll be it for Bahamut.
Ooh, the slowdown. Interesting.
That cannon is just epic. It's so good. Oh, Bahamut, you fired the wrong direction. No, you're going back into those knives. That could be a big mistake for Bahamut if one of those knives grabs hold. Oh, but he's so quick to the draw, though.
Indeed. I love that. It's beautiful to see Faction 4's spin shoot.
Oh, he's surrounded, Bahamut. Oops. This might be it for Bahamut. Can he take... He's got to get out of there. Oh, and one nuke! Nuke to the face, knocked out the front end of that ship. Another nuke destroying part of that modular cannon. Weakens him substantially, but maybe not enough to stop him. Bahamut is such a beast, I tell you. Look at him go. He's fighting all the way down. He's made his escape. Fantastic job.
Yeah, you have to imagine the Faction 4's, the Faction 4 civilization as these... These creatures that are able to think super fast, because they're not even concerned about the fact that there are nukes all around them. They're just like, wait for it, enemy fire!
Imagine them like that.
Oh my gosh. Spin on the knife point. Yeah. That's a little gun. Flipped! So you spin
to Oh, almost took a knife to the face. I'm kind of rooting for Bahamut. I mean, I don't know. I really want to see Bahamut do... Well, because he's the only single ship competitor in this tournament, but I don't know. All it's gonna take, those guns are just so fragile. All it's gonna take is a couple more hits. He might pull this off. You know what? He might just pull this off. Nuke!
Ooh.
No! Bahamut goes down in a blaze of glory.
You do realize it's our fault, right?
It's what?
We jinxed it, Rob.
What happened? What did I do?
No. I'm just joking about the fact that we were just like, he's gonna win this. He's gonna win this.
I know. Yeah, maybe I jinxed it. But Bahamut, and he's already lost his right side armor. Waste 47 is not wasting any time this time. He's getting in there. He's digging, and he's got it behind. This could be interesting. Oh, we got some serious slowdown here.
Serious slowdown here. Oh my gosh. Here's the other problem. When he shoots away, he happens to ram himself into the ships sitting behind him.
Yes, so, and that's exactly what happened. It cut right through the left side there. Oh, there it goes. I think he's done. He can't turn anymore. There it is. Waste 47 steals it from Bahamut. Bahamut still has one more loss to go.
Oh gosh, Bahamut.
All right,
Drone Dreadnought versus Imperial Expeditionary Force. Okay, Supplecrumb versus DDP.
Dreadnought. What, sorry?
Sorry?
DDP, did you say?
Dreadnought, Drone Dreadnought Power.
Oh, okay, DDP, gotcha.
Sorry. Kung Fu Master, yes.
Kung Fu Master.
Ah, Bahumato, you Kung Fu Master. Sorry, I'll stop being racist.
Is that racist? I don't know. I don't know if that's racist. I think you're appreciating.
It's more of a joke, Dave.
Yeah, I know. We've had this conversation many times. Whereas, you know, you do your Russian accent, I'm like, is it racist? I don't know. I think you're appreciating the Russian accent. That's what I think you're doing. But yeah. I don't know.
That does mean that this is how I interpret it. After all, I speak it, I enjoy it. It is fun. It makes people laugh. So I mean, why not yours? It'd be more of a crime not to. So you know, it's just like a brachum of it, I guess. What can I do?
Drone Dreadnought just got owned by Nukes. Wow. Jeez. Wow, what a cleanup of Nukes. So yes,
I had such hope for them.
I have hope for them, but I just think there's just too many Nukes in this competition. How do you deal with that? And
For the Empire, Sumplecrum.
Love this fleet. I love Sumplecrum's fleet. I just think it is just gorgeous, and the fact that it's Faction 7, and he's got that extra layer of spike armor there, it just looks so good. Just love it.
it looks great. I cannot remember the Superstar Destroyer, which is so sad.
From
so
Emperor Strikes Back?
No, I can't remember it.
It had a blue haze through the whole thing. You need to go watch Empire Strikes Back again. It looks like that ship. It looks so good.
Oh gosh. Yeah, I need to rewatch Empire Strikes Back.
It was the most epic ship in Empire Strikes Back, for sure.
It's the most epic ship, period.
it's a pretty amazing ship, the Superstar Destroyer. It looks so good. It's the one that started, because they didn't have a Death Star to play with, so he flew around in his little Superstar Destroyer.
Yeah,
Darth Vader.
They didn't have a Death Star to play with. That's a funny mistake.
Yeah.
I imagine now Darth Vader with like a little play Death Star.
Dreadnought takes his first class.
Also with a little toy Alderaan, he's just like bumping them together. Pew 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 pew.
Oh, Bahamut is challenging the Drone Dreadnought. If Drone Dreadnought loses this battle, he is out of the competition. Bahamut, I have a feeling, unless those drones can get in there and start dealing some damage, Bahamut does have defensive lasers, so I don't know how Drone Dreadnought is going to deal with this.
I don't think he can, unless he gets close enough, but his ships just aren't fast enough. Look at that.
Cuts! But he's still, it's still taking a lot to get through that armor, though.
Yeah. But, I mean, Drone Dreadnought power has 0 points, so...
Hello, Caleb. Sorry if I'm not watching chat that closely. Every once in a while, I look over and I just answer a question or, whatever. There we go. Yeah, I don't know. I think it's just too slow. Those Faction 1 drones are too slow, and they won't get close enough if, like, the ship has to be... they won't go far away from the ship. I'm surprised Bahamut even flew that, like, took the chance of closing that much.
Yeah.
He's only destroyed two ships, though.
Yeah, well, there's a lot of armor.
Yeah.
Actually, a lot of the drones are trying to go, so I think they get stuck behind the other ships. You know,
they're taking the long way.
MSS. I'm going to go look at Mons' current 20.
His what, sorry?
I'm going to go take a look at Mons' current 20.
Current tournament. Okay, yes.
Yes, I'd like to take a look.
I don't understand English sometimes.
Oh, no, it's fine. I'm not talking properly. That's fine.
Speaking your Russian accent, I can understand you clearly. I don't know.
Can understand the Russian accent, but not the English one. My gosh.
Wonderful. It's going to be points. It's just going to be strictly points for Bahamut. He's having a real trouble killing those ships.
Yeah, it's also all the little drones that the Bahamut keeps shooting out. The act is also a little bit of an extra point gaining process.
I don't think he's getting that much points for the drones. I don't think. Hold on, let's.
You'd actually be surprised how effective having a few little drones on a faction for Dreadnought can be. I've played around a bit with a few of my own ships.
I thought you were saying that the drones that Bahamut was shooting out, he was getting points for that, and I didn't see that.
Happening. Oh no. No, sorry, that's not what I meant. You see, you cannot understand the Russian either.
That's no, I problem. Don't understand English. It's just I can't understand anything anybody says. That's what my problem is.
A shame, bro.
But Drone Dreadnought, you have done 13 points of damage, so good on you. Yeah, you got in there. Good. You did a couple points. That's good. At least you're not going out. I mean, this is a skunk. I'm afraid this is a skunk.
Skunk.
Well, no. I've never heard that expression before. You've never heard the term skunking.
I've never heard it.
Maybe it's only a crib thing. If I've ever played crib.
No.
Okay. Well, this is something that your grandpa teaches you crib. It's an old school card game, whatever. And if you get beaten by a certain amount of points, it's called skunking. Which means it counts as basically two wins. There we go. As far as points go, 49,971 versus 66. That would, in my books, be considered a complete skunking.
my grandfather taught me Nomination Whist. That's the game he taught me.
What game is that?
Nomination Whist.
What is that? Is basically, that a card game?
It is a card game, yes. Basically, it's kind of... There's no good game to compare it to. Basically, the idea is to try and each round you obviously get a set of cards or whatever. So the idea is to try and like guess how many suits you're going to win, and then try and win that many suits. And then if you get that many suits, you get points. If you don't, if you go over or under, you don't get as many things. And then whoever has the most points by the end of like seven rounds wins.
It's kind of like Hearts, isn't it? That sounds like Hearts.
I don't know Hearts, so it might be, yeah.
I mean, I don't know. I haven't played Hearts in ages, but that sounds similar to Hearts, I think. But whatever. Hey, interesting. Interesting. You'll have to send me the rules to that one, and I'll challenge some family members.
it's extremely fun. I've played it with quite a few of my family members, even some cousins who've come over. Absolutely hilarious. It's just because people get so crazy about it. It's just like, if I had called one more, damn it, one more.
So is that played with just cards, or do you have a board or something?
Just cards. You should also just get a pad of paper so you can keep track of people's points.
Well,
per
I'll
round.
Tell you what. And also, if you send me the rules for that, I will send you a crib board. A Canadian crib board. No, seriously, I will, with the rules. And no, I'll totally do that, because you can learn some Canadian games, and we'll learn some South African games. That'd
we
be fun.
We get to teach you crib?
Yeah. The lovely Lisa is in the background here. Say hi, lovely Lisa.
Hi, oh my gosh. Lisa.
She said hi, lovely Lisa. Yes. She's excited because you get to learn crib. She loves crib. There you go.
She's like, that's good. Really interesting. All right. Excellent. We'll arrange this someday. Maybe get like a tabletop simulator. That could be fun.
Oh, that'd be fun. Oh, that'd be super fun. Yeah. So we're just killing time as Bahama just pounds on Dro Dreadnought from a distance, not doing enough damage to actually destroy the fleet, but certainly shaming Dro Dreadnought because he just can't get close enough. I know if those drones got in close enough, they, you know, maybe if he, in quantities, he might be able to do enough damage. But even then, with the defensive lasers of Bahamut, I just don't think it's impossible. But Drone Dreadnought has done 135 points, beating his high score with Bahamut.
yeah, it's the problem with projectile, with like point defensible projectiles. You can they're relatively easy to stop if you have enough point defense. I mean, like drones. I mean, Terran faction drones. Like they're quite easy to stop if you have just meager point defense. Well, not maybe meager, I mean, quite a bit. I mean, by the way, just waste them. Just
look at that. Just gone.
Just
dissolved.
Like a little bug zapper.
Oh, but look, the little guy, he's shooting. He's like, I got the armor. Never mind. I got him. Oh. This little guy is like Luke Skywalker. I have him. I have him. Yeah. And then Bahamut, that's it. You're done.
And then Bahamut just says, I'm on the leader. Just gone.
Ah, beautiful, beautiful job. Oh, Bahamut. No, he still didn't take those little fighters when they hit that armor. Doesn't do anything. And they're even stuck in his armor. It's like a fly trap. Brilliant.
Oh my gosh.
That's great. The little drones are stuck in his armor. Fantastic. 8 seconds to go.
As well. Oh, if only they'd survived to do anything. The problem is that by the time they got there, their lifetime ran out, so they were starting to construct. Oh, shit.
Oh, one final blow for Bahamut. Oh, or against the Drone Dreadnought. Beautiful shot. Destroying a lot of drones in its path. That's... getting away. 4 seconds to go.
Can I also just point out that Drone Dreadnought's actually constructed very well in that his side... His side chunks, like those, what do you call those sidings? They're actually held together by about three different, like, struts, which is interesting. Yeah, so if you take out one, there's still support.
Excellent.
Quite good. Well, alright!
They fought valiantly for Faction 1 Extirp. That finishes you off, unfortunately, and you're out of the competition. Oh. We're now on to Mons Pubis versus Centurion Skipper B. Interesting fight this might be.
Yes. And, well, good rhyme there, Rob. Good rhyme.
Thank you. Thank you very much. All right.
So, Mons Pubis is going to be shitting at the enemy to them.
That did not sound like shooting. Oh, wow. Okay. All right, folks. He's going to be shooting, not whatever Lap said. That did not sound like shooting.
Oh, dear creator. What is going on? I don't know. I don't even know what you heard, but
it didn't sound like shooting. What sounds like shooting?
Okay, anyway. Moving swiftly along. Skirmish Forever is skirmishing forever against Centurion version 2, of whom is trying to nuke him but cannot because Skirmish. Skirmish does not like nukes. Skirmish is not friends of nukes. Nukes is not friends of Skirmish but can never get close enough to befriend Skirmish. Although he does try. Nuke does, however, get popped by Skirmish Bullet. Skirmish Bullet is very dangerous, very scary, and lots of it. That is Luke's assessment for 2017. Thank you.
Please, you got the year right. That's good.
Sorry?
You got the year right. You're better. You're ahead of me already. That's good. I'm still in 2016. I haven't accepted 2017 yet.
I nearly did say 2016, but anyway.
Good job. Good job. I don't know. Mons Pubis is down to 24 ships. That's pretty close for his points. I don't think Mons Pubis is ever getting behind that armor. Oh, never mind. He's already penetrated that armor, but I don't know. He's still dealing with those little ships. I don't know. What do you think, Luke?
I don't know. I was trying to read trap, Rob.
Whoa, what happened?
I don't. Time? I think time.
Oh.
I think time ran out.
Okay.
So, wait, so what happened, Rob? What are you asking me?
I guess that was Mons Pubis for round one? Okay. I didn't think we were out of time. Yeah. That was weird. Mons Pubis, round one, and then we're on to round two.
So, Rob, what are you asking me, by the way?
Oh, I was just wondering what your thoughts were on who was going to win it, because I think... I'm surprised. I thought that Centurion was going to pull it off. I thought that those nukes would actually get ahead of Mons Pubis and start knocking out ships. But I don't know. I guess I'm totally wrong. Actually, you know what's funny? It's Skipper B. He doesn't have a lot of nuke ships. Like, I don't think there's only those three ships have nukes, right? Maybe.
I can't see any nukes on the main craft. I think also partly uses the main craft as distractors. Because most I see on them is missiles, really. And he leaves the nukes up to the little ships since they're actually going to maneuver around, get behind the enemy. Yeah. Do that sort of thing, I guess. I don't know. But, by the way, it is 8:27 my side, so we have been going for an hour and 27 minutes.
Oh, sorry, Luke. It's going to be a long one today. Are you okay to go on for a little bit longer?
Yeah, no, it's perfectly fine.
quite often, just as a warning to those people that are watching, after we've been streaming for about 2 hours, things start to get weird. We start to talk about pretty weird stuff, usually.
Well, I mean, we say weird. Is it really that weird, or is it just slightly disconcerting and creepy?
All of the above, yeah.
All of the above. All of the above, excellent. That's surprising. Right. Deluxe, you misread again. Centurion won first round.
Oh, Centurion won first round. I thought it was Mons Pubis. Okay. I misread. Apparently I misread. Skirmish Forever, Mons Pubis wins round two.
Now
that means we're going
now
on
Mons
to
Pubis wins.
Round three. Here we go.
Now Mons Pubis wins. But now not Mons before.
So neither of these competitors have lost a battle yet, so whoever loses here still gets to go on for another round, which is nice. Kaijudo Mage says things weren't weird already. No, it can get way weirder, trust me. During the third or fourth hour of a stream, things have gotten really weird. Yeah.
Oh, the third hour of a stream. We ignore the tournament and go off into completely depraved subjects. Depraved? No, crazy. completely crazy subjects, like cockroaches. And
like,
phoenix.
Oh, yes, I remember somehow. The cockroach. And that spawned a meme, actually, which is interesting. But that was also when we used to stream at, like, I used to start at, like, 2 p.m. my time, which is, what, midnight for you or something ridiculous?
It was 2 a.m. my time, actually. It was, it was 6 p.m. your time, 2 a.m. my time.
Yeah, and then we'd do that for like 4 hours. So by 3 or 4 in the morning, Luke is a little off. And because Luke is off and I've been streaming for a long time, I'm off too. So it makes for some interesting conversations.
It really did. I remember actually having a tournament where it went on until the sun came up for me.
That we had together?
Yes, it kept going until the sun came up at about 6, so that was a 4-hour stream.
What does your family think? Like, what is family? What do people in the household think when you're streaming all night long and talking nonstop?
I honestly don't know. They try not to comment on it.
They don't talk to me anymore. They stopped talking to me about the time I met you, Rob, so I don't know.
Oh, God.
I'm so sorry, Luke. I'm so sorry.
It's okay. Funnest and most damn hilarious moments of my life so far.
Jonathan Champion says, Deluks, imagine doing a 12-hour stream. I have streamed for 7 hours. I think that's my record. It's not huge compared to some people. Skipper B wins it. Good job, Skipper. Don't worry, Mons Boom, you get another chance.
I'm glad you were paying attention, Rob.
I was watching. Interesting. Xenos versus Mons Poobus.
Ooh.
Some nukes right away. Oh, look at Xenos is in there, like, skirmishing. Like, this is a dogfight. Look at this. Oh, yeah, beautiful. I think that's actually Mons Poobus's, that's maybe his weak point. He's not really good at dogfighting.
Oh. Which is funny to think about a faction 4 fleet, a skirmisher one, that is.
Oh, yeah, gosh, but they need to have some distance, I think, between them and the enemy. I think if the enemy gets in too close, it's not good for them. It's just like Bahamut's ship, just a smaller version. All it takes is one or two good hits, and it knocks out those modular guns, you know, or whatever, and then it's over, right?
Yeah. Oh, jeez. This reminds me of not this so much as just talking about the Faction 4. This reminds me of the time I went up against Camo with Faction 4. So that was a long time ago. Oh, gosh, Don.
I don't remember that fight. I don't remember that fight at all. Camo was using his Faction 4 ships?
Yes. It was still 1v1 ships. I sent in a Faction 4, he sent in a Faction 4, and somehow we made it to the very last round. So all it was me and Camo left. I won one round. I got one round. So Camo won the first round, I won the second round, then Camo won the third round because the AI was stupid.
My ship literally did something. Isn't that frustrating? Oh, man.
It was. My ship did something it hadn't done before and never did after. It stopped and turned left and let Camo shoot it to hell.
You know, I still think Camo makes deals with the devil, because stuff like that happened all the time. When Camo was fighting somebody, people's ships would do crazy things, and then Camo would just pull off this one singular shot and knock out, you know, the core in one shot or something stupid. It was
damn
ridiculous.
Hilarious. Yeah. So far, Xenos has one win. Mons is going down.
If Mons loses this battle, he is out of the competition. If Xenos loses this battle, he's out of the competition. And I still think it's anybody's game, although, hey, hang on. If Mons keeps all of his ships together, maybe. But see, look at Xenos just flies through spinning, flying all the way through his fleet, and then boom. Mons doesn't know how to deal with it.
Oh, gosh. Just funny. I love this dogfight. We need some, like, return of the fighter tournaments.
Yeah, there's been a lot of talk about that. People are asking about that, and I might do that. It's not going to be right away, though.
Well, more like three little squad. So, like, you'll have seven. So you have seven ships to play with, each with like a maximum of say 500p, and that's basically what you have to roll with. That'd be interesting.
That would be interesting. Yeah.
Agreed.
I'd like to see every one of those ships that you have, like all seven ships, distinctly different for every fleet. Yeah. That would be really cool.
And also, you should, I think that would actually be a good point to give a sort of weight limit. Could be interesting. You never know.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not opposed to it. The tournaments have been okay. I think people have come to watch some of the tournaments, and it's
oh, no, oh no, oh no, yeah, no, definitely. I mean, I've enjoyed it, and I'm the one who has to commentate the bloody thing.
Oh, I love it. I absolutely love
yeah,
it. Yeah,
absolutely, absolutely love it. I'm just saying that as an interest, as an interesting project, maybe, yeah.
Yeah, so Skirmish Forever, one round two, it's anybody's ballgame.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm surprised.
Kaiju says that spin to win.
Spin to win, yep.
Spin to win.
I don't know. If Mon Pubis wins this, I will be... I don't know. See, these two competitors, I expected to be, like, part of the final two. So it's funny that they're fighting so early. You know, or part of the final four kind of thing. But, you know, now that they're fighting early, that's just, it opens up, like, who's going to win this tournament? I don't know.
Yeah.
I think, you know, I don't know. Skirmish Forever, the points are close. 30 seconds to go. I am so surprised. I thought Xenos was going to clean up on Mons Pubis, but I'm wrong. It's close, though. It's close. 20 seconds. I don't know. I think Xenos is going to finish him. Sorry, Mons Pubis. Here comes the rest of Xenos' ship, and they kind of run in there. Like I said, they come in really fast. They scatter you, and then they just bump you a couple times, and they knock out some of that first initial armor. They come in, hit you with those beams, and then it's all over. Yeah, there it is. Xenos takes it. Good job, Xenos. Mons Pubis leaves the tournament. Wow.
Yeah.
Crazy.
Oh, she's like it. Just like it. Yeah, toch. Crazy stuff.
Waste 47. So two faction 7 fleets, both of them, I don't know. Again, I don't know. But look at the little ships bounce off of the big ships. That's amazing.
Yeah. Melee armor.
Melee armor. Oh, chipped off some of that melee armor. Oh, here we go.
Pew. Pew, pew. Ba, ba.
Two, three, four, five. We're down to 5 competitors in this tournament, folks. 5 competitors left. We're coming down to the final 4. It's very exciting. Very exciting. Waste 47. He's actually doing pretty good. Pretty good. He's got nukes too. So if he gets a couple well placed nukes on that Super Star Destroyer, I think he can take it down. I don't know.
Yeah. I'm pretty sure one nuke just to the back there would decimate it.
Pretty much.
Explode radius. Yeah, it would kill the command, because the range is big enough.
Well, he's got to something soon. 46 seconds left, and 147th has 33,000 points versus 20,000 points. Oh, here comes the nukes after the capital ship. Oh, close. Oh, right near the back end. Oh, no. Actually, that might be their own nukes. I don't even know. I can't tell whose nukes are whose.
Yeah. Oh, gosh.
Look at the furry missiles chase that guy down.
Ah, furry missiles. Furry missiles.
Furry missiles. Not the furry missiles. Don't you mean the flurry missiles, sir? No, I mean the furry missiles. Damn it. Oh, nuke to the face. Pretty much disabling that capital ship. It's all over. Here comes some more nukes. Oh, I think that's all friendly nukes. Okay, lucked out there. Oh, shatters him in half. Waste 47 pulls off the lead in the last few seconds. Amazing job by Waze 47. Amazing. Yep.
Well done, Waze.
That first round of nukes, it's oh wow. You know, I'm not surprised that Waze 47 pulled it off, but I thought he was gonna do it sooner than that. I guess it just depends on how many of those little ships he targets versus the larger ships, because those larger ships are definitely at a disadvantage fighting a nuke fleet for sure. Oh, nuke. Ooh. To the capital ship. Oh no, that pretty much puts you in the ground, Sumplecrumb, I'm afraid. And Sumplecrumb have you taken any losses yet? No, this will be your first loss, Sumplecrumb, if Waste 47 wins it, but you're ahead in points. You just gotta stay alive now, buddy. I don't know. Luke, is it getting late for you?
No, I'm just, it's 8:38, yeah. It's 8:38, it's quite late, but I'll be fine.
You only have a few more battles to go, I promise.
Sorry?
Only a few more battles to go there, Luke. Oh, Simplecrumb may actually pull this off.
Ah.
He Go actually on, killed a couple of those aggressive on, ships there and nuked him. Come on, Supplecrumb.
I think that nuke to his main, all that did was make him lighter.
Yeah, it made him lighter. It's like, oh, we got rid of all that pesky armor. It was just slowing us down. Look at him go. He's just cleaning up. Supplecrumb is going to win round two. Unbelievable. Oh,
my word.
I don't know how many. I don't think Waste only has 8 ships left. Do any of those ships even have nukes left? It's possible that Supplecrumb. Unbelievable. Nice take back for Supplecrumb. Round three.
Funnily enough, Supplecrumb says, my fleet wasn't supposed to get this far.
It's done so well. I'm so impressed. Jonathan Champion, there will be no after party today after we are done the main event tournament. We're not going to be sticking around. Luke needs to get some rest, and I have other things that I need to do today. And this is going to be a pretty long tournament. So, yeah. Go ahead.
No, I was just going to say, this practically is the after party of the entire tournament. It's all the champions fighting against each other.
Yeah,
what
like,
more could you ask
it.
For?
Yeah, this is it.
Maybe.
Yeah,
maybe
Jonathan Champion. Yeah. What's that, Luke?
I was just saying, I was saying, what more could you ask for? And then I'm going to guess maybe throwing a few Titans in there. but that's for like next week sometimes.
Yeah, so we're going to be planning the Titans tournament possibly next week. It's going to be a wonky tournament. And it's going to be hard to keep my computer in one piece and holding it all together because there's some pretty crazy designs. I don't know how we're going to do that. We might just do one battle at a time, like one ship against another, and then whoever wins that will go into the next one and stuff. Just in case we get crashes, right? Yeah. We'll see.
Yeah, we should, you should get, there's a randomization, website, isn't there, where you can put in things and have it randomly give you
we could totally do that. Yeah, we could so basically
you take randoms and then every two you put them against each other.
We could totally do
those,
that
do that thing
totally
yeah it should
that.
Be fun. That could make it way less crashable.
Against all odds, Supplecrumb has won this. Oh, maybe not. Nuke to the face. No, in the last moments, Waste 47 steals it from Supplecrumb. Unbelievable take back once again from Waste 47. He did the same thing he did in round one. Supplecrumb had it in the bag. Nuke to the face. It's all over. Supplecrumb.
Just like
you have
in my heart.
First loss.
In my heart, I feel
that
Supplecrumb won.
Oh, that's heartbreaking. Supplecrumb is not lost. He is now facing Bahamut, who is flying into them for some reason. Okay, he's backed off. Okay, good. Woo!
Oh, gosh, Dawn.
There's a lot of small ships coming in.
Go, Supple. Go, Supple.
Oh, Bahamut.
Oh,
no, he's
trying to talk.
Why are you...
ships.
Fire, Bahamut. What are you doing? Bahamut, no! Nuke! First nuke hits. More nukes coming in. Bahamut is being swarmed, and Bahamut doesn't know how to deal with it. What's going on? The AI has forgotten how to fire the cannon. Unbelievable, he's lost almost all his outside armor, but he's still 98% combat effective. There you go. Bahamut escapes. I thought he's going the wrong way. No. Oh, here they come.
Splinterman says, the game of nukes.
Yeah.
Oh, gosh.
Bahamut. Okay, he's taken a lot of damage, but I don't think any of his core systems, except for maybe a little bit of the left side cannon. He could still win this. Sure, I don't know. I think Supplecrumb's ships are just a little too fast. They get on top of him too quickly, and Bahamut doesn't know how to deal with it. He doesn't flip quite as quickly as he has been in the past. I don't know what's going on with the AI here. There we go. But every time Bahamut shoots, he is taking them down, for sure. He's lost. Poor 147th Imperial Fleet has lost. You know, he's down to 11 out of 37 ships. He's lost a lot of ships, 26 ships down. And here they come again. Bahamut's is, I think he's just trying to aim more carefully or something. I don't know. Nuke, multiple nukes. Oh, and Bahamut goes down. If Bahamut loses the next round, he is out of the competition. If Supplecrumb loses the next round, he is out of the competition. I have a bad feeling for Bahamut here. Are you still alive, Luke?
Yes, I am. I'm just, I don't know what to say.
Sorry, I talk too much. Yeah. You know that.
No. It's literally just I'm not sure what to say. The nukes. And, so yes, Supplecrumb has one win.
Bahamut just cleaned off a good portion of 147th's little ships there, though, so I don't know. That might have been the turning point. I think Bahamut's going to win it this time because there's still quite a few of those small ships. Maybe. I don't know.
Yeah, exactly. It depends whether or not Bahamut actually targets and manages the fire. Kind of dictates the survival.
He's killed off... I think that finishes off all the small ships with all those small... One more small ship to go. With all those small ships gone, all Bahamut's got to do is keep range... Can he do it? I think he can do it. I think Bahamut's going to win it this time, guys. That's my prediction.
It's definitely in his favor right now. He's managing to flip. It's the interesting thing about Faction 4 flippers in that they basically rely on their gun to, you know, keep them safe. And the moment that fails them, they're
done.
In for a...
Yeah, they're done.
It's just like the original one-on-one Tinkerels.
Yeah.
When you build your snipers and all they did was shoot and just fly all the way away. And there was never any hope of beating them.
Well, essentially... go ahead.
Yeah? No, go.
Essentially, Bahamut's ship is a sniper ship. I mean, it's not a skirmisher. It's a sniper ship, and it keeps that range, and it's using that gun to keep that range. It is a sniper ship versus fleets, and it's just proven that design is still solid in this situation. And if we ever did a fleet tournament again, I would probably specify a mandatory ship count, a minimum ship count versus the one. Although, I don't think it's been unfair. There wasn't too many people that took advantage of the one ship design. And I don't think it's not the meta, obviously, because Bahamut... No, Bahamut, what are you doing? No, we made it to round three! No!
Wow.
He used the tactic of not moving or firing. That wasn't a good
exactly.
tactic. Bahamut leaves the competition, sadly. Sadly, you're right. Out.
Oh my gosh, yeah. Now we get to see Supplegrum versus the counter, V5, my Xenos. Oh, the nukes. The nukes.
Yeah.
I'm honestly very interested to see how this goes out.
The capital ship just went down. Jesus. Sorry about that, Luke. I didn't mean to scream in your head, but...
No, it's fine. She's like a...
That's it. I think without the capital ship, he doesn't stand a chance. I think that pretty much finished... Oh, Jesus. Wow.
Yeah, that's the other thing about capital ship warfare. The moment you lose it, you've got nothing else.
Yeah, you put all your eggs in one basket. Those eggs may be delicious. But you lose that, you drop that basket, and that's it. They're all cracked, and they're no good for you.
Splinterman says the octagon dance. Do 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 do. I don't know where this was referring to, but
I can imagine. But it was fun to listen to you sing at least once this time. So
yeah. I guess Bahamut had empathy and went, "It's okay, it's okay, Splinter." Not Splinter. Yes, I mean Supplegrum. You can go on. You can go on, Supplegrum. Go next. I know ways to move with you.
Of course, making a list. He's writing down Supplegrum's name on that list, and of course, plotting his demise. Because that's what people do when they care that much about reassembly. It's like, how am I going to destroy him one day?
He's making a list. And he's checking it twice. He's going to find out if you've nuked him twice. Then he's going to come and nuke you. Do do do. He sees you when you're building. He knows when you're online. He knows if you're using Faction 4 or Tinkerel all the time. He is coming for you. Do 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 do.
Bravo! Oh, gosh. As you were singing that, I'm like, you know what's the creepiest line ever? He sees you when he's sleeping. That is the creepiest line ever in a song. He sees you when he's... It all depends on how you sing it. If you say, he sees you when you're sleeping, it sounds okay. But if you say, he sees you when he's... When you're sleeping. If you say it like that, it's much different.
That's even creepier.
Yeah.
Why the hell is he sleeping? I don't know. Seeing you?
Whatever. What a creepy line anyway. But good point.
That was out the clause.
Supplegrum's winning this time. If he doesn't lose that capital ship, he's fine. Well, I don't know. Still some nukes in the air, but I think Xenos only has 5 ships left, and... possibly a couple more nukes coming in.
Sumple's winning on points though, so yeah. I'm not too sure. Oh my gosh, Sumple, if you're gonna win this out of luck, it's gonna be hilarious.
I would, no offense to Xenos, because I think Xenos is a favorite here, but I'd like to see Supplegrum win this. I would
too.
And then it's not because I dislike you, Xenos. It's because I think your fleet is excellent, and I think if Sepulchre. Oh no! 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 And no! Xenos steals it from Sepulchre. Just stole it right out from under him with a nuke to the face. Once again, leaving Sepulchre out of the competition. We are down to three competitors, folks. Three competitors. Waste 47 versus Centurion. If Centurion.
Give me a second, Rob. I need to just plug in my headphones.
Okay. If either of these competitors lose this round, they get to move on because neither of these competitors have lost a round yet. Waste 47, or unless I'm miscalculating here, but I don't think either of these competitors have lost a battle yet. So this is going to be a game changer. Whoever wins this one is going to determine who's in those final two for sure. I don't know though.
Well, Centurion has lost one, technically.
Has he?
But yeah, jeez.
Well, he's lost a battle, but he I don't think he's lost a three rounds. Yes.
He hasn't lost the game.
Yeah, he hasn't lost the game yet. So,
you know, it's interesting because in a normal game, Waste would be the winner right now.
Why would you say that?
Because it's down to the last two, isn't it?
Or is
it
down to three. We've got Xenos, Waste, and Centurion.
Okay. Centurion hasn't been beaten. I'm sorry. I'm thinking of Waste or something. I mean,
Xenos is the only one out of those three that's taken a loss. So if Xenos loses one more, he's out of the competition. These two competitors that are fighting right now still can afford a loss.
Yeah. it's very interesting to see because technically, right now, we are seeing the last battle, if you're thinking about the normal game. So whoever wins this, theoretically, would have won the entire round.
Yes.
The entire game, which is funny.
That's right.
Entire tournament.
That
but
word.
Because we're doing double elimination, it's actually not going to be like that. It's not going to be a different sort of outcome to the normal, which is kind of funny.
My preference, if it didn't take so long to accomplish, I would do double elimination all the time just because it's a little bit more fair, in my opinion.
And we got to see that Xenos was a superior fleet to quite a few.
Surprising.
We got to see quite a lot of people. I mean, Xenos basically fought everyone in there.
Yeah, pretty much, but he has taken one loss from Splinter. Splinter got him that one time.
Yeah.
Which might be a big disadvantage now in the final three. Skipper has...
Splinter's not here, is he? So, that's a problem.
Splinter's here.
No, I mean, his...
Oh, Xenos? Yeah, his name is Nil in the chat.
Centurion. Oh, Centurion. Wait. Centurion is Splinter.
No, Centurion is Skipper LB. I don't think Skipper LB is here. No, sorry, you're right about that, yes.
Sorry, Yeah,
sorry about that. Okay. And Waste 47, who's Waste 47? I know him, I can't remember the name.
It's Waste. It's just Waste 47.
I thought he had a different name. I thought he went under a different name too as well in our chat in Discord. Maybe I'm wrong, but
Let me take a look in our chat.
My money's on Skipper LB here. I think Centurion's gonna pull it off. I was pretty close. I think Centurion might even win this tournament. It's going to be close, but I think Centurion might just pull it off. I don't know that they can... They're not going to be able to deal with those nukes from Xenos very well, but I think they might... Actually, that's funny, because Centurion still has so many little ships. It keeps them preoccupied. I think Centurion... My money is actually now on Centurion to win this entire tournament. I don't think it's going to be Xenos. I don't think it's going to be Waste. I think it's going to be Centurion.
Yeah, that superior circle design.
It's the superior circle design. It's amazing that he did a circle, by the way, and that it's all one block and it's all interconnected. That in itself is an achievement.
There's also a ship stuck inside it. So
well, yeah,
that's
he's running security right now. No, he's docked for lunch. He's like, I'll get a burger, a fries, and what size is your milkshake coming? Oh yeah, okay, I'll take a medium. Chocolate. He's docked there. He's like, yeah.
It's just like, don't worry about the wall. My team will do it. It's fine.
He's like, it's all right. We got this. It's okay.
We got this. I love that idea.
That's
amazing.
Great. Dock for lunch.
Yeah, I can't remember. He might actually be offline. So that might be the...
Okay,
in fact,
there we
he
go.
Is offline.
Centurion pulls it off. That gives Waste his first loss? Or second loss?
Yeah.
think it's his first loss.
First loss.
Yes. First loss. Now, waste against Xenos. This is going to be interesting, guys. Ooh. A very similar, very similar fleets.
Knife.
Both dogfighters. Who do you think? What do you think, Luke?
I have no idea. My gut feeling would say waste because of knives, but I mean, Xenos has his hyper-maneuverable little nukers, so I feel more inclined towards Xenos right now.
I'm thinking that too. I just think that those the circles, his little circle ships, maybe don't move as fast as Xenos's little ships, but I don't know. I really couldn't tell you, because waste is actually winning it right now.
Yeah. And by the way, Waste does go by the exact same name in our school.
Okay, my apologies, Waste. Yes, yes.
It's okay, apologies. Waste.
I thought he might have had an AKA. Some people have AKAs, like Xenos. Xenos has Nil, right? So that totally confuses the hell out of me.
Well, thankfully Nail? I don't know
Nail.
How you say
Nail.
It.
Nail.
Yeah. At least they use, you know, the same-ish, you know,
graphic
icon.
Yeah,
they're same. Graphic icon. So he uses the little swirly yellow and like lightning. He uses his whatever that is.
Yes.
whatever it is.
I don't know what that is.
I don't know.
I think it's a mine. Is that a Minecraft thing? I don't know.
I think it might be a Minecraft skin, but it looks like
Waste
a face.
47, 16 seconds to go is going to win this unless something else changes. That's round one. If he wins round two, it will knock Xenos out of this competition. Either whoever loses this battle, this entire battle, will be knocked out of this competition, which will leave us down to two competitors.
I thought it was going to be Waste, honestly. Because
I thought Waste was going to be knocked out. Yeah, no, Xenos won it. Xenos got him. Round two.
You mean Waste got him?
Waste won, right? Waste won.
Yes, one wins.
Yes, so Xenos...
You said Xenos got him.
I meant...
Confusing me even more.
Totally, I'm just trying to confuse everybody, you know, watching.
Break our minds. Oh, dear gosh. Run, everybody.
Oh, in chat, they're like, ban circles.
Ban circles. Ban squares.
From Centurion. Ban the circles. Can't have circles on your ship anymore. You know what? That circle, you can laugh, but it probably took a lot of work to get that all connected all the way around. Like, it's pretty amazing that is all one continuous piece all the way around. That's pretty crazy. Good old yawn near the final two here. Or final three. I know. It's getting late for you.
This has basically been 2 hours. No, it's fine. But it's basically been 2 hours.
Well, you should have a nice big cup of coffee before bed. That'd make you feel better. Xenos is coming back, though. Xenos might pull off round two. It's funny how the AI just decides, well, we're going to play things totally differently. Xenos is playing it totally differently, and he's grouping up a little bit better, I think, this time. Kind of singling out Waste 47 quite well. Maybe got a couple good nukes off there, and he's actually knocked it down. He only has 11 ships left. Waste, I don't think he has any chance. 15 seconds left. Round two is going to go to Xenos. Whoever wins round three... I don't know, but I will say this, Centurion still has not taken a loss, so he would have to lose two full rounds of battles against whoever wins this in order to, is that right? Am I saying that right? Because Centurion has not taken a loss yet in this tournament, whoever wins this would have to beat the Centurion twice.
No, only once, actually.
Only once?
There isn't an additional, isn't there any more slots?
I wasn't sure about that. I wasn't sure, because it is double elimination, right?
Yeah, I mean, well, look, honestly, it would work best that way, but I guess it would just be silly to have the same people fight each other again.
I guess that kind of makes sense.
Yeah.
But interesting that Centurion hasn't lost one up to this point.
Yeah.
And you wouldn't expect, at the beginning here, I probably would have said Mons Pubis, Xenos, Bahamut, and...
Yeah.
Yeah.
Turns out none of them.
Well, yeah. It all depends on what happens here. Xenos still may win this entire tournament. Or Waste. Sorry, either one could win this entire tournament. My apologies, Waste. You know what? The fleets are so similar in so many ways, except that Waste has a slight... His builds are slightly bigger, and of course he did a little bit... Actually, I would say that Waste ships are a little bit prettier, maybe? But I do like that non-symmetrical design. I don't know.
Yeah, Xenos is taking a slight point lead. Headbutt. But it's close. 2000.
It's close. Yeah. Too close to call. 20 seconds to go. 27. 1,000 points between them. 12 seconds to go. It's gonna be the difference of a nuke or a couple random shots. Waste pulls into the lead by a substantial lead. 4,000 points. Unbelievable. 3 seconds to go. And Waste pulls it, steals it from Xenos. Amazing comeback from Waste. Xenos, you fought so well, buddy, but you're out of the competition.
Yeah, so we're going to see the exact same fight again.
Here we go. Waste versus Centurion. And this is it, folks. This is the final battle of tournament number 11. Unbelievable up to this point. Who has actually landed here? It surprised me all the way. But I will say that Faction 7 has dominated this final.
Definitely. 7. Oh gosh, insanity.
What's your prediction here, Luke?
Oh, well, I'm gonna have to say Centurion since he won the last round. But I mean, I don't know. Waste could be crazy. I don't know.
I think I predicted about 3 times that Waste was going to lose over and over and over, and then he's come back unbelievably in the last few seconds of just about everyone that he's been in here. So I can't predict anything anymore. It's going to take, it could be the deciding factor, could be 3 nukes to the face to one of these Centurion ships, these big Centurion ships, and then finish it off. That's the same thing he's done in every single round with Waste. It's crazy.
As you said, nuke to the face, one of Waste's little spinner guys literally drove into a nuke and took a nuke to the face. It was hilarious. Bah, God. Oh gosh, darn.
Yeah. points very close. Very, very close.
Yeah.
It's, you know what? It's funny. It's not the nukes that, I mean, the nukes of course are a factor here, but for Centurion, it's been his ship design. It is the design of his ship that has won this battle allowed him to do so well. I mean, it's not his weapon loadouts. I mean, it's typical weapon loadouts. He doesn't have an enormous amount of nukes. He has some small ships that have helped distract the enemy, but at the core of his designs are these large, I want to say troll-like ships, but they're not troll-like. I mean, they are troll-like, I guess, in design. They're slow, but they're not too slow, but the armor is so well-designed. I don't know. It's just a really good job. Oh, knocked out! Centurion's almost knocked out one of... two more nukes coming in. Oh, so close. Almost knocked out one of those big ships. The points are so close. 4 seconds to go, guys. Waste is going to pull it off. Unbelievable. See? Once again, Waste has surprised us all. Unbelievable.
Yeah.
One more round, and Waste could finish this entire tournament winning the t-shirt.
Usurping our expectations.
Usurping our
just like that.
Great word. Usurping our expectations. Challenging what we all thought. Waste is unbelievable. Unbelievable. I thought Centurion was going to take it. I thought, wow, they've actually penetrated Centurion's armor right away. One of Centurion's big circle ships penetrated the armor. I can't even call it. I mean, I'd like to say that the AI does crazy things in round two, so maybe Centurion will win round two and then we'll see a round three. I don't know.
Gosh, they're maintaining a solid point difference. About, what, 2,000?
Yeah, but Waste has come back. It doesn't matter, Waste. Oh, big blow for Waste. Waste took some big hits there. I'm not quite sure exactly what he lost. He must have lost multiple ships at a time there. That was a beautiful hit. So, putting Centurion almost 10,000 points in the lead. 48 seconds to go. Could Centurion win round two just by points?
I think he's going to win round two.
You think so? I don't know. Yeah. Waste 47 has surprised us every single time, coming back in those last few moments with a barrage of nukes.
Yeah, but he's scaling slowly. He's getting there. But Centurion is climbing at the same pace.
Same rate, yeah. 30 seconds to go. Can Centurion hold that lead? I don't know. You know what? Those little ships Centurion brought in are small enough and maneuverable enough just to keep Waste distracted enough from making those final blows against those Centurions. But now the nukes are starting to come in. They're coming in hard, too. Waste could pull it off in the last few seconds here if those nukes start making some serious lands. He's got to do better than that, though. 10 seconds to go, guys. We're going to see a round three. Maybe. Look at the nukes coming in, though. Oh, yeah, we're going to see a round three. Centurion takes a distinct lead, pulling it off in the last couple seconds. Good job, Centurion. Excellent work. Centurion wins round two. One final round for tournament number 11.
Circle, Kaiju says, circle versus circle equals circle wins.
Yes. Band circles. I know. Oh, nukes. Heavy nukes at the beginning here. Oh, wow. Nukes doing a lot of damage to Centurion right off the bat, but actually, Waste is kind of staying really close in there. I don't know. Luke, any predictions? Any predictions?
I don't. Waste has got his little point lead, so. Waste got his point lead, so I'm gonna back Waste.
I would love to see Centurion with this.
I could back Centurion, but I don't know.
Both of these competitors are absolutely brilliant. Brilliant fleets. They've done very, very
well. Look at
well.
Centurion. Watch Centurion. He's climbing now.
Yeah, he just nuked a couple of those ships. Yeah.
Robbie is a funny thing. We back Centurion, Waste wins. We back Waste, Centurion wins.
Okay, so I guess I don't know. It's so hard to tell. Waste has that lead again.
He does. Come on, Waste.
50 seconds to
Come
go.
On, Waste.
I'm rooting for Centurion because I feel like he's kind of the underdog in this, maybe. But I don't know. I can't really say he's the underdog. He hasn't lost a battle yet. Or like a round, like a full.
Look at that, 20,000. 20,000 to 15,000.
Centurion's coming back. Unbelievable.
Yeah, he's coming back. Well, Centurion, moment to prepare your postal code. or where you'd like to pick up your shirt.
Now, if the winner of this does not want the shirt, does not want to give me their address, I totally understand. I will go down the list, so I'll go to the second place winner, whatever. But absolutely, if Centurion wins this, he gets a shirt. If Waste wins this, he gets a shirt. I just have to mail them out to you maybe a couple weeks before that arrives. Really exciting. The last 15 seconds, Luke. It's close. It's too close to call.
Exciting.
I think Centurion's got it. He's going to win by points. It is
8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, oh. 2, 1.
Centurion! Zero. Centurion wins tournament number 11. Amazing work. Beautiful job. I am absolutely amazed by the results of this tournament. It is not what I expected. I am just bravo. Bravo. Absolutely bravo. Everybody that was in this tournament were worthy competitors. I am super impressed.
And if enough people don't want the shirt, maybe I can get it.
Yeah,
yay!
We'll go all the way down the list. Yeah. Sorry, Luke. But we did, on one of the after-party shows, we did actually pit your ship against Bahamut's, and you beat Bahamut's. And Bahamut was one of the winners of one of the divisions. So it's interesting that if you had faced Bahamut during that tournament, you might have been in this, you know.
I could have gotten a damn shirt. Whatever, I would have been.
Sorry, Luke. Sorry. There will be more shirts in the future. I'm going to be ordering some more. This is just the first edition of that shirt. I only had one left. Otherwise, I'd send you one just for being a co-host.
Shame. Shame. Oh, Waste. You got so close.
So close. You fought very well, and everybody deserves a big round of applause, actually. I'm super impressed. This was a really fun fight. So that was tournament number 11, guys. We are going to be doing the Titan tournament possibly next week. It just depends on our schedules and if everything goes well. Ooh. That'll be next Saturday. Big ships.
Delicious.
Delicious carnage.
Maybe we can get a shirt for that. Can we, precious? Smeagol wants shirt.
Juicy sweet, good to eat. Sorry. Anyway.
Shame, Gollum.
Absolutely wonderful.
It's
thank you.
Misrepresented.
Yes, I know. Poor Gollum. Actually, I think we do a Gollum quote just about every tournament. I think we do something from Lord of the Rings.
Something from Lord of the Rings. Yes. Anyway, well done, everybody.
Well done, everybody. So hopefully we'll see you next week. Otherwise, Luke, where can people find you if they need to find you?
If you want to find me, if you want to enjoy my insanity and my depraved mentality, then you may come and hunt me down at Lapsapnow. Lapsapnow, or Lapsapnow. I have a YouTube channel. You can also find me linked. You can also find me linked to myself. That makes no sense. You can also find a link to my channel in Rob's channel. Support my comrades section. Yeah. Yes, you can
also
you can
in
find
the description of this video too.
Also in the description of the video. And if you have made it this far, and if you are hearing this, well done, sir. You get 1 point. Doodly doodly do.
What happens when they get 5 points?
There's
no you don't get points for anything else, and everybody always ends up with 1 point, and that's it. So everybody wins! Yay! It's like everybody gets a participation ribbon. That's fantastic.
Oh, yay. Oh gosh. Okay, you know what? No. Just to not allow participation ribbons.
No, I'm not a supporter of that. I do not support participation ribbons. You've got to come out and play to win.
You've got to win, damn it. I don't get a participation t-shirt, do I? Do I? So you're not getting a participation
this ribbon. Is going to be a sore point, I'm sure. I'm going to hear about this for months. Remember that tournament where I got nothing? Nothing! Sorry, Luke. Sorry. I'm going to be ordering some more shirts sometime in the next year here. I'm sure we'll find a way to get you a shirt. And a crib board. Absolutely delightful. All right, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for joining us today. It was, and joining us for the entire tournament, it was a blast doing this once again. As far as actual main event tournaments, it's going to be a while, but we might come back and do something else. We're going to discuss it in our Discord channel. Please look in the description down below to join our Discord channel and come chat with us and give us all sorts of great ideas or tell us how we're wrong or right. We love it all.
Yep.
Luke, what do you think, Luke?
Sorry, Rob, you're breaking up slightly for me.
Oh, sorry. And anything else you'd like to mention to the crew there, Luke?
What can I say to you people? Well, thank you for joining us and for sending in your ships. If you get 5 points, you get a little trophy that they'll send to you at some god unknown date. Besides that, thank you for joining us, being in the chat to talk craziness and make us laugh. Thank you for joining us and sending in your own fleets to battle. And besides that, thank you everyone for joining us. Until next time, cheery rear yo.
Wonderful, wonderful. Thanks, guys. Bye, bye, bye.